This is fucking... Wait, no, it's from a main channel, isn't it? Oh, right, yeah. Gotcha. Let's put a goddamn timer here. Ugh. Clearly audio isn't working. Give me a sec. Hello? I'm just checking. Wait. Can I actually be heard? Wait a minute, why can't I hear it? Why the fuck could I not hear this? Nani kurasai? Maybe I have my audio settings completely wrong. Oh, yes, I do. Of course. Naturally. I had my actual speakers as my source. Oh yeah, I did sleep well. I had 6 hours of sleep. That's all a boy needs. Let's get people on seats. It should be fine. Should be completely fine. I am not very much prepared for all this. I am never prepared for this streaming experience. Even though this is now the goddamn sixth time we're doing this, I will still not be used to it. Okay. Fine. I'll change the slow mode. I'll put the slow mode down to 10 seconds. Yeah, fantastic. Thank you for the diamond, Seth's daddy. Right, okay, fuck it, I'm gonna actually just fucking plug right into this. I'll try and answer questions as quickly as I can. Let's answer questions before we go deep in. Has the hentai money been paid? Yeah, we got it, boys. We actually got it. So I'm gonna basically wait until they actually try and put it on my account. Once it's on the account, I've already got like stuff that's earmarked for the hentai commissions on my PayPal, and we'll see how it goes. I don't know where to put the poll. I might put it inside the Discord. What tribe do I belong to? The most dangerous tribe of all, the tribe of Israel. How many loaves of bread have I eaten in my lifetime? Quite a few. I think bread is a much more common staple back here. Shall we do redistribution? I actually forgot to do redistribution last time. Right. This is a very early time to really start the redistribution. If I do the poll, I think I will post it on the Patreon. I'm gonna figure out how we can do the poll, because I want one where we can extend our answers. So I think there's a couple of polls online. They've got APIs that can do that. I think collectivism is fantastic. I think collectivism is really, really great for everybody involved. Hey, since there's not too many people here and I can actually get away with saying all of this stuff, I could actually tell you a little bit about why I love collectivism so much. Because our family kind of lost everything thanks to great collectivism. Because we were German Jews on the wrong side of a border. And being German Jews on the wrong side of a border, this is way back. Basically, Germany was getting crowded. You could not really get cheap land. So my family at the time, they thought, hey, let's move into what was Russia at the time, Tsarist Russia. Now, I can try and find you the region on the map. I'll give you a little history lesson. 'Cause the borders have moved, actually. The borders have moved, and there was some territory previously that would have just been considered part of Russia. So our family owned an estate, let's say, a very large estate. We were responsible for, let's say, a small region around here. We're kind of responsible for all the processing of grain, grain milling. Now, well, Tsarist Russia sort of came to its end because, well, the Bolsheviks came in and they basically grabbed my great grandfather and everybody else involved. They actually got sort of a tip off by the locals that this is gonna happen. So they managed to mostly dart away unharmed, but then they sort of just got caught trying to escape the country. And then they were given two options. Either you can go to the Gulag and rot there for the rest of your life, or we can take you where we send exiles and other undesirables who are, you know, not down with the proletariats. So they were deported. They were deported real far. How far? Yeah, real goddamn far. Now, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, they were partially under the USSR umbrella. They were called a Soviet Republic. And it was a great place to send people off into exile. So, from my family, we were essentially deported to, I won't tell you the exact region. I'm just gonna tell you Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, or Kyrgyzstan. And a really fun story related to that collectivism, because I thought it was an interesting little tidbit. Now, my grandmother actually saw the estate in its complete state of disrepair. Our estate, which was responsible for grain milling and it was quite significant for the region, is essentially now a dilapidated pig farm. There's pig shit and dirt everywhere. And yeah, apparently she fainted when she saw that, which is pretty good. But it goes a little bit further because collectivism does not just take from the people who possess stuff. Inherently, in a system like that, collectivism disrupts and it also takes from anybody who replaces the taker. Now, interesting thing about our estate. So, grain milling, quite important for the region. What happened? They had a micro famine. They had a micro famine because there was nothing to really mill the grain. Because, you know, all these proletariats and all these very self-righteous peasants who were down with the Bolsheviks, they did not know how to operate all that machinery very efficiently. So what happens in that situation? They elect a member of the proletariats to take over this estate and manage it. This is called a kulak. And I found out what happened to this kulak. It's really like a good mantra for all of communism. This kulak took over the estate, and then the people found out that, Lord forbid, he's making money off of grain milling operations on our estate. So you know what they did? They hung him. They killed him. They killed him. And they got a new kulak. And I don't know, the trail sort of ends there. They probably got rid of several people who manage the estate. It's a big contradiction. You have to take over state resources, but you have to make no money. So, yeah, that's a little bit of a background. Here's a little history lesson for you. And this is why our family loves collectivism so much. And you know, we were so upset when we had to get out of all of that and actually move to the West. Because, you know, one annoying thing about the West, right? You can keep all of your assets and the state does not repossess your assets. That's kind of a problem, you know? I think my grandfather also lost all of his assets when the USSR actually fell, because he saw the signs that the USSR was going to fall, but he didn't think it would actually happen. Now, the smarter members of our family, they actually emigrated long ago, so the rest of my Juden family, if you're interested, they are somewhere in Ontario. We don't really have much communication, but the other half of my family is like in Canada. The people who did not emigrate quick enough and change all of their currency, unfortunately, they went broke the next day. So I think my granddad was very pissed off because he was something about 50 years old. He had a pension and everything like that, and all the savings are just gone, wiped out, gone. Yeah, so this is a little bit of a background. This is why I don't put it on fucking 10-second mode.
Years.
Let me just check
This
that
is.
it. Yeah, looks okay. What a goddamn Reddit move. Okay. Maybe I should increase it to 15 seconds. Yeah, that would be nice. How's the weather? How's the weather? The weather's fucking terrible because it's the UK. The UK always has amazing weather. And wait. I actually don't care about numbers for this goddamn stream. This is the stream finale, though. I'm gonna actually just check if we can forcibly emigrate some people from YouTube. Give me some time. Give me some goddamn time. No, I actually should stop doing that. I don't want to get in fucking trouble with YouTube. I have enough trouble as it is. Okay. No, because I wanted to start the stream on YouTube at the same time and then make everybody come over to DLive. But fuck that. I don't care. This is the finale stream because after this stream, I'm not going to stream for a while. I think we gotta savor the moments. But you know, thoughts on the Holocaust. YouTube does get jealous. Let me show you some stuff. Because apart from videos, I also have to make some shit for people's birthdays and so on. So I guess you can see like the worst shit that I've actually made. Hey, I do feel some shame, but I guess you are obligated to see this. What the fuck is this?
Hello? Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. Yeah, I can be heard. I can be seen, but I'm utterly black. Okay, let me test if I can actually vape through this thing. Because apparently you can vape through this fucking thing. Wait. Yeah, boy. It sure works. Okay. Time to never be a white man on camera again.
I had a lot of terrible requests for stuff. We can go through these just one by one. Jesus Christ.
Hey, how's it going? It's pee squeezing time.
What the fuck is this?
Hey, people.
Oh, I should give a little bit of a context. A very infamous furry whose OC is an inflation fox girl asked me to record some voice lines. I do this for free, by the way. Only if I have time, though.
Hey, hey, people. Seth here. And tonight, as per my viewer request, I am dining on the ass of this voluptuous wolf ass. God forgive me.
Okay. let me actually give you a reference to what that looks like, because I think we do got a reference for it. This is what it actually looks like. He commissioned it. God bless him. What else do I got in these folders? Wait, Ozzy Mozzy is hosting me? What does this do? Jesus. And I also, oh, okay, before I show you like some other garbage that I actually put together, I have so many copies of Hava Nagila. Some of these are copyright striked. Is this MIDI Nagila? Exactly how I remember. Okay, wait, how many DVs I have? Oh yeah, yeah, for people who only came in like recently, yes, DLive paid me. We got the money. I'm gonna check if a transfer actually goes through. But yeah, I'll open up a poll on Patreon and in the Discord for what the hell we actually have to get funded. I'm a lot better now with pricing hentai, because actually the first time I funded all this hentai for the God Hand video, one of the problems was I did not know everybody's price points, so I was just like, hey, whatever, we'll pay whatever the fuck you guys want, and it actually meant that I had no real control over quality or anything like that. I think a lot of it was actually good. You want to click on Mandalore talk? I think I recorded just us talking for one time. I needed to make the perfect waifu. She's so far made out of my shit and jankum, but one day she will blossom. What the fuck is this?
Christ.
But yeah, you make nice stuff. Congratulations. I saw you grew really, really quickly. And you have an orbital power beam targeter, which is like...
So, like, we are coordinating with people, like, but I've heard...
Yeah. So what they're doing is they... Listen, so many of them were crying that I fucking hate my mom. If my stupid whore of a mother actually reproduced with a white guy and actually made me white, I'd be having a much better time. But no, instead she chooses, like, this ugly fucking Negro. Now I become, like, this fucking mulatto piece of shit with his dilated, like, fucking nostrils. And I look like, you know, a little dark goblin.
Man.
There was even, like, an Indian who was saying, like, you know, he has no chance, he's 5'3", and now he's getting, like, alopecia and a receding hairline. He literally looks like a brown Kinder Egg. Oh, no. I should actually give a context to this. What I'm talking about here, just so I can explain myself, this is a site that got taken down. It might still be up. This is incels.me. Yeah, I'm talking to him about incels.me. Incels.me is a very interesting site Oh, maybe they actually changed it. Oh! They might have remade it. So it was a site where people basically bitched that they're an involuntary celibate. And one thing that kept coming up all the time... This was words that were actually said by the people. But they actually described themselves terribly like that. And, like, you would see people who are essentially race-hating on their own race. I've never seen another place where a guy could be, you know, from a white mother, a black father in America, and he basically just says like, oh, I think my mother is a whore because I'm uglier now because my mother reproduced with him. Now I have no chances in the genetic pool. This is the kind of stuff that people say. And it was such a fucking amazing forum because every day, at least a good 20 people would be banned. Just for the fact, let me hit you with this. They got banned from the incels.me forum for being too handsome. Or, Lord forbid, being a woman. And one of them was like, a guy was like, well, I don't really feel very confident with women. You know, I'm a little bit on the short side. I'm about 5'2". You know, it's kind of, you know, girls want to be a bit shorter. And I don't really have chances. And then he just posted a picture of himself. And the admin basically said, get the fuck out of here. You think you've got it bad? Oh, forgive me. I'm 5'2". Look at your chin and jaw genetics. You've got a fucking Olympian jaw. And you're complaining to us that you can't get any. Go fuck yourself. Literally, get the fuck out of here. And there's like another case. There's another case where it was just a girl. And it was a girl just saying like, you know, I actually have not had opportunities to date. You know, I've never even had an opportunity to have sex because, you know, I had a very restrictive childhood. And, you know, I was just wondering, how do you even meet people? Because I do have like massive social anxiety. And the admin just popped in and said, get the fuck out of here, you stupid goddamn femoid. There is no such thing as a female incel. You could literally walk into anywhere and, you know, it's like a snake mating pit, you know? There's going to be 100 snakes which will just latch onto you immediately. Yeah, that's the context. I like how I had to explain the goddamn context of the shit that I put up. What else have I got for you guys? Let me show you another one. Wait, what the fuck is this? Let me just check.
No. It's not working, man.
Sorry, that's just my friend with a great microphone. What is this? Does this open with WebM?
That's so gay.
Hello,
you faggot.
So you're a queer, aren't you?
Fag, queer,
faggot.
we were gonna do like a dramatic reading episode on incels.me, but I think I was too busy with other stuff. The other problem with that was I just felt it was a little bit. It was getting more to the edgy side rather than the fun side. Oh, wait, somebody made this ages ago.
Hello, Merchants Guild. Seth needs your help escaping Uganda. In order to escape and get Hirsch his heart, he's going to need...
he said the line a little bit wrong. He was meant to say get Hirsch his HRT, but obviously Pete is so innocent, he doesn't know what hormone replacement therapy is. Okay, continue.
Heart, he's going to need your credit card number, 3 digits on the back, and... the expiration date, but you need to hurry before the German government assassinates him with kebab. Huh. Thanks, man. You're the best.
Actually, since we looked at VoiceOver Pete, there was one thing I did want to show you guys. But I did not have a good segue for this, but now I do. I have a guy from Estonia, and his name is Fyodor, or Ivan. He keeps saying your friend Ivan, and he just wanted to say, if you actually show this stuff, please show some of his photography. It's quite nice photography. Some of the stuff is actually all right. Okay, let's get to the stuff that he actually found. Apparently, in Estonia, all of his ads actually got fucked up, and he was getting PMC military defense ads for shit that he could buy, essentially from a company called Rafael that develops and manufactures advanced defense systems for the Israeli Defense Forces, the IDF, and sells it to anyone who wants to spend the shekels. You'll find out why I said this is a good segue from Pete. So, he's getting ads like this.
Air superiority with the Python 5 iDerby and iDerby ER missiles from Rafael. More than 65 years of expertise, from short to long range, operational and combat-proven missiles for air-to-air and air defense. iDerby is an active radar short to medium range look-down shoot-down missile. With both lock-on before launch and lock-on after launch capability, it performs exceptionally well in both short range and beyond visual range.
Oh, Mountain Merchant, I will review Hotline Miami.
The iDerby missile incorporates several cutting-edge high-performance technologies. iDerby's many advantages include active radar look-down shoot-down, all-weather performance, low-al and low-bull capability, dual range, fire and forget, large kinematic envelope, advanced ECCM capabilities, dual use air-to-air and air defense. Rafael presents iDerby ER, an innovative active radar air-to-air missile for short, medium, and long ranges. iDerby ER has a dual pulse rocket motor for long-range intercepts, 100 kilometers launching range.
100, wow. Oh, actually, yeah, considering this is aircraft range. Love these animations!
iDerby ER has new kinematic capabilities and lethality warhead.
I will review Command & Conquer General sometimes.
It has a solid-state RF seeker, enabling full operational flexibility, and can be used as an air-to-air and air defense missile. Missile design enables simplified aircraft integration.
This as well.
Multi-range missile, look-down shoot-down capability, advanced solid-state RF seeker enabling all-weather operation, robust high-performance ECCM.
I'll show you the other one, because the other one is, This one has a fucking sick soundtrack, by the way. We gotta fucking put this on full screen. This is a tank drone, but this is a tank, and with drone capabilities, it actually has a commander view, so you don't actually have to stick your head out of a cockpit. The other thing that it's fucking got, this is a tank that is crazy enough, it's got the active protection system, so if there's a rocket coming to the tank, it launches a countermeasure and kills it within, like, before it actually managed to do impact. Okay, well, let's watch this shit. I mean, okay, say what you want about this shit also being advertised on YouTube. This is fucking amazing. Another thing that happened, because he told me a little bit of stuff. So Raphael does a lot of supplying for the IDF. The IDF has the Iron Dome. The Iron Dome is essentially, they've got a surface-to-air missile countermeasures. So whenever actually a missile is launched from Palestine, if it's a Palestinian rocket, it can actually be intercepted and killed off. Now, Raphael had a little bit of an incident, because you know what happened? When the tracking is going off, the missile is meant to have like a perfect intercept path, and then they explode. Now, even if they don't actually meet their target, they have to explode. And there's a reason, because the actual, the exact fuse timing and so on. Wait, let's see. What is it exactly? Oh, yes, it's, to put it short terms, it's the actual fuse timer and the exact detonation mechanism. Now, what happened with Raphael, they had a little bit of a scandal. They had a missile that did not go off, it fell in the Gaza Strip, and it did not self-detonate. Now, unfortunately, that is a military secret. If you can get hold of a detonator and the actual mechanism, you can reverse engineer that and actually, you can actually, you know, adapt to that. You can actually then make a rocket that will not be intercepted correctly. So, that's Raphael's little fuck-up. Now, can I show you, why we were doing all this time? Enjoy.
More news now from Raphael. Their drone dome defense suite is proving to be the most efficient solution against hostile drones used by the terrorists to perform aerial attacks, counterintelligence, and carry out other intimidating activities. Designed to effectively detect, track, and neutralize drones classified as threats, flying in no-fly zones, the drone dome inflicts minimal damage to the surrounding urban environment while maximizing safety to friendly aircraft.
The Drone Dome Defense Suite by Raphael.
Yeah, you can have the exact link. I don't know if this will stay very long in chat. okay, yeah, and this is how we did that little segue. Oh, he's waking up. Oh, he's actually fucking waking up. Okay, how do we do this? How do we do this? Okay. Give me 5 minutes to prep. Okay. I didn't tell you guys, because this is like the last episode that we're gonna do for a little while. We got a celebrity cameo. We got Mr. Can Ash Corp, who's gonna go read some terrible stuff with us. Me and Ken have known each other for a long time, but the first time we actually properly spoke was like quite recently. And I've got, what's it? Wait, I can actually show you, like, a few actual things. Yeah, that's the actual king. And, wait, let me just show you some more shit.
Uh-oh, you frickin' moron. You just got... Tag your friends to totally...
It's some terrible shit. Most of this is actual fucking garbage. I'm very sorry. I'll go through these and then we can actually get to stuff with Ken.
Ocean man, take me by the hand, lead me to the land that you understand. Ocean man, the voyage to the corner of the globe is a real trip. Ocean man, the crust of a tan man and by the sand, soaking up the first of a land. Ocean man, can you see through the wonder of amazement at the Oberman? Ocean man, the crust is elusive when it casts forth to the childlike man. Ocean man, the sequence of a life form braised in the sand, soaking up the thirst of a land. Ocean man.
Yeah, I had to do somebody's birthday request. I'm sorry about that. Let me show you the CBT recording.
Cock and ball torture. Cock and ball torture, CBT, penis torture, or dick torture, is a sexual activity involving application of pain or constriction to the penis or testicles. This may involve directly painful activities such as genital piercing, wax play, genital spanking, squeezing, ball busting, genital flogging, urethral play, tickle torture, erotic electrostimulation, kneeing, or kicking. The recipient of such activities may receive direct physical pleasure via masochism, or emotional pleasure through erotic humiliation, or knowledge that the play is pleasing to a sadistic dominant. Many of these practices carry significant health risks.
Yeah, good, good, good. Now we can finally get on to actual stuff that matters. Wait, wow, this should be in memes. Yeah, very good. No, it's terrible. It's a terrible video. This will not be uploaded. Gay furry requested in this area. Hey, how's it going?
Hey, hey, people.
Get fucked. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good. It's currently 8:43 a.m. I'm feeling fine. Apparently you've got a lot of good stuff lined up.
Oh yeah. No, it actually managed to take a bit longer than I expected. So we actually still have stupid shit to watch.
Oh, wonderful. Wonderful.
I'm not sure how we're going to do that, like, together, actually. Let me see. Wait. I have an idea. Because this stuff will not take long. It's about, 20 minutes? 20 minutes, and we'll recall. And then I'll get you to read this terrible shit. Because otherwise you can't see this.
Not a problem. I'm glad that you played everybody the cock and ball torture video. Hello, Epic Gamers! Rise up, but before you rise up, he's gonna need your credit card. Give Seth all your Chinese lemons.
Ken, please. Wait, actually, no. If you're still watching this, there'll be a delay. Okay, 20 minutes. Yeah. I'll catch
you
right
see
back.
You then.
Yeah, I know. We'll do some shit. Okay, see you soon. Okay, because I wanted to. This is actually my original goddamn intro. Also, let's do collectivism. Redistribute the goddamn rewards. And let's see. It's, This was meant to be the original playlist I would play at the start, but then we got sidetracked with defense contractors. Anyway, let me just show you some shit.
Boy, I'm in this club slow-mo. Don't mind if I do. And I can tell you're feeling me from the jump. I wanna ride too. You got that hot shit. Boy, you're bad. Let me fill up on your chest. Flexing. You the man. You the man. If you want it, I'm gonna be ba ba boom boom. If you got it,
have a headache, I recommend ibuprofen. Just take 400 milligrams. Okay, wait. I wanted to show you just some terrible shit. It won't take very, very long. Do you guys like anime? Because one of the best animes I've ever watched in my time is one called Gundo Musashi, Gun Samurai. It was basically called the worst fucking anime ever. Took ages to make. Managed to blow all the budget, and this is what we got. Don't worry, it's got subtitles. Don't need to see more of this. There's a few nice compilations of how good Musashi is. Okay, let me show you some stuff. This one will take about 7 minutes, but this is a good summary. You just need to see this quality in its full glory. Translation, fuck you doing, man. This has the best battle scenes. Enjoy.
ナスミを働く悪党に。たくあん様が終わりになると思っているのか。案外気に入ってくれちゃったりして。おざきよ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ。よっ
まだまだ。
You, if you like frame loops, you're gonna love this.
Yeah.
こんな相手と戦っていたのか。
This is an amazing fight scene. This is from the same guy who actually animated Lupin the Third, by the way. This demon is approaching at like high velocity all the time, and then they forget about this. No, not the cleaner. But you'll find out this cleaner is much better than a cleaner. The demon is still approaching at high speed. Kind of homo, but thanks, bro. Oh, right, it's not done. Okay. This is another epic fucking fight scene where a woman learns her place. By the way, the gun that Musashi has, can I just explain this while this is happening? Because the fighting doesn't start yet. It's a sleeping gun. So it's a bullet that puts you to sleep. His sword also puts you to sleep. This is the actual lore. I actually watched Gundu Musashi. You don't mess with a goddamn cleaner. He's basically telling her that she doesn't understand the art of a gun. She doesn't respect the gun. That's why she's using it as a melee weapon. Gotta respect the gun. Oh shit! But she doesn't respect the gun. The gun won't work for her. Okay. I have only a few snippets of this stuff. I used to watch a series that was made entirely ironically, but it made a lot of anime people mad. Because it was just an anime that was just done shit on purpose.
Don't you just love mochi ice cream, Koneko-chan?
Oh yeah, mochi ice cream's very good, Raku-chan.
Desu! Oh, I'm really full.
Gotta love these walking animations. Enjoy.
Koneko-chan, look at that guy over there! Yeah, he's so sugoi! Desu!
Well, I just happened to be walking by, and I saw you two lovely ladies walking. How you doing, kawaii? Neko girls, nya rar.
I should go see Hanya.
Okay. Episode 1 doesn't have good shit. That much good shit. Wait. You need some of the best moments here. I know all of this. I watch Neko Sugar Girls religiously. This is how you have to begin every day of your morning, by the way.
Oh, what a nice morning is to eat some breakfast. I'm gonna go downstairs.
Walking animation!
Some nice pocky and ramune. My favorite. Well, time to chow down. You're coming with me.
Anyway, he gets kidnapped. Episode 3. Wait, I wonder what the good parts are. Wait.
Get away! Like I said, we're just gonna have some fun. I'm not even supposed to be here. You have no right to hold me captive. There's freedom in this country. This is America.
Okay, wait, what else is there? I think episode 4.
It's very sunny outside today.
Okay, I have to show you something advanced here. Anyway, she finds a cute ass squirrel. She pets this squirrel. The squirrel obviously bites her. I have to put the volume to 1%. Because this was just designed to blow out people's speakers. Thank me later. It's not over. Wait. Oh yeah. Wait, there's a best moments compilation. This is fantastic for a reaction image, by the way. Wait. Enjoy this part.
We're trying to get into the vet, but the door is locked.
Don't worry, baby. Let the man handle this.
Che cabron. It's empty. Yeah.
Well, it is 3 a.m.
Were you Neckos here all night?
And that's what I had from that. Let me show you a little other thing. I don't know. I randomly found this goddamn video. It had 77 views. I don't know. It was while I was playing Diablo 2 Median XL.
The rat men are small dudes found in the catacombs and possibly other places as well. But I found them in the catacombs. They are small dudes with spears. If you don't like small dudes with spears, then you will definitely not like the rat men. Because they are small and they have tiny spears ready to poke you with them, make some new holes for you. That's disgusting.
Okay. This is the last thing, and then we're gonna do some other stuff. Back in the day, I loved how anything like showed you like how to fucking crack Photoshop or anything like that because you had the best fucking music, but usually it did not have good quality editing. Enjoy this. After this, we're actually going to do some stuff. This is the most hype fucking hex editor video. Tree man. Able to get much money. Okay. Anyway, that's done. This is done. We've actually redistributed the chest. I think that's done. Oh, we can actually redistribute more. Give me a minute to actually piss. I'm redistributing rewards right now. One sec. Oh, Jesus, why are you guys giving me so many goddamn lemons? Jesus Christ. That's far too many. I know this is a finale and everything, but hey, they're not worth that much. Raku gets... Oh, Ken was thinking all the same things. Hello. Hello. Brother.
Hi, this is Mike Miller. I'm not currently available, but do you know what is available
The
App Store and the Google Play Store? That's right, it's Raid Shadow Legends!
I'm sorry, this stream has been co-opted by Raid Shadow Legends. Where's the logo?
Use the offer code Seth to get 50,000 silver and a free epic champion.
Wow, how much is that worth?
It's worth absolutely nothing.
I even managed to find a high-quality logo. Jesus Christ. Oh, wow. Raid Shadow
Raid. Shadow Legends.
Wait. This is just like a... Is this turn-based or something? It has to be.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I've never played Raid Shadow Legends, so I have no idea.
Right, okay. I don't think I'm ever going to start trying to play Raid Shadow Legends. Right. Oh, Jesus. I'm sorry. To explain, me and Ken are going to go read some dramatic readings and shit like that.
Look at what this man sends me. Look at what this man sends me. This man is Dick Chasen.
Oh, wait.
He's Richard Chasen.
Wait. If this is a fantastic reaction image in case your homies bail out on a social arrangement, the trade.
Kevin Williams, The Return of the Legend.
Oh,
betrayed.
Okay, I'll show you the ones which I really liked, because there's ones for every region. How the West was hung. What else? There's a lot that I didn't show you, actually. There's Slammer. If you can't do the Warden, don't do crime. 11 hot men. 5 scenes.
2.5 hours. 5 scenes. Directed by Brian Mills and Harold Gregg.
Hey, I haven't showed you the one which has featuring Dante from the Devil May Cry series, Bret Michaels' Jackhammer, also starring Dante. And it's so good because it's like JoJo's Bizarre Adventure because Jackhammer is calling up the stand. He's got a stand, which is Duplo Gay.
This party's getting crazy!
And there's also Trespass! And I thought it was Shooped. It was Shooped.
All I can say is the guy at the bottom, ultra manlet mode.
I thought like the composition was so weird. I thought he was actually the leg of a guy in the background, or that he was like the little dog.
The epic adventure of the year.
There's
bonus
also Cowboy.
Scenes.
Cowboy. Some men are just born bad.
Written, produced, and directed by Blue Blake. Big Blue. Gotta have that Big Blue. Oh, yeah.
Stop crying. Take it like a man. Oh, wait. It's Scandinavian. Oh, of course it's from
Scandinavian
Sweden.
Erotic. Will I see Mads Mikkelsen in this?
I doubt it. I doubt they have a budget. But you can get a Bruce Cam feature
Eruption.
Here. Yeah, this is about the events of Pompeii. Oh, the one I like this one as well. Double check.
An All Worlds video presentation. Jerka and Karel Barton.
It's Bartok. It's Czech.
Oh, Bartok. Sorry. Barton. Joey Barton. Eh.
Okay, since we're so fucking deep, I may as well just put the other gifts Adam keeps sending me.
Nope. Don't like it. Nope. Don't want it.
Okay. Oh, can I just show you guys the other thing? I showed this to Ken yesterday, but I have to explain it to me. One of my friends showed me an art book. This is a real art book. It's called Solutions for Drawing the Clothed Figure. Dynamic Wrinkles and Drapery.
And Drapery. By Bern Hogarth.
Okay, then can you just read out this next one that I'm posting? So somebody was somebody was in an IC thread on 4chan, and they're like, oh, why do you have a Photoshopped version of Dynamic Wrinkles and Drapery? I've got the real version right here. You could please read this whole thing.
Dynamic Wrinkles and Drapery by Herr Hogarth is the final solution to drawing the clothes figure. This is the final solution.
Right.
Those stripes won't hang themselves, and neither will the Jews.
Okay, Jesus Christ, you can't actually say this on stream. Well, I mean,
as long as I don't say anything bad about China, I'm fine.
I don't know, because you can give an I get N-word passes from people. I don't know if I can get giveaway Juden passes. I don't know if that's a power that I have.
Homie, you dropped your Jew pass. Here, let me give it to you, Goyim.
Okay, whatever. Yeah, let me just post this one.
Harry! Harry! He's got a gun! It's Sam Hyde, the notorious mass murderer! I know, Ron. It's Sam Hyde.
Wait, I don't know why I have so many pictures like this. Sorry, this is just my folders. I need something that's normal that I can just post here, and then we can just use it as a filler, so that nothing else bad is actually being seen here. What else do I have?
This is actually me. Why did you post this picture of me?
Oh, okay. I have all the stock photos of hackers. I think that will be fine.
I'm about to take on the government and then end my own life. Oh yeah!
I loved it because I found so many hacker pictures because I was getting them for the Evanical review as well. There's just so many goddamn good ones. I had to not use about half of these because they didn't really work. Is that all of them? Yeah, wait, that's how many I found. This is a small selection, Jesus, by the way.
Jesus fucking Christ. Do you think the Discord has, moderators that just have to sift through every single image that's ever uploaded, in a cache?
Only looking at this? Only if it's actually, reported. But the interesting thing is, if something does get reported, they'll have to see it. So, and it doesn't get deleted if you actually delete it. It's still in the archives and so on.
Mm. Yeah, I kind of guessed.
Well, my main dude IRL isn't exactly a UN peacekeeper. Put it this way, he's representing the main military forces at the DR of Congo, but this is 2012, this was ages ago, and now the rebels basically went through their base. I don't know actually how he is. Probably was captured. It's even worse because I tried to track down Agutu Mbike. Unfortunately, the reporter, the journalist who reported on his case, he's in jail right now in prison in Egypt because of his journalism. Because, of course, Egypt does not like people snooping. Ken, shall we read this stuff? Right, we should tell people what the fuck.
I think we should. Yeah. I think we should read this stuff.
Yeah, time is marching on. Right. I might as well just tell you what the fuck we're reading. So you guys know D&D? Yeah, D&D does not cut it. We're gonna be reading... I can't link this. This is too big.
It's far too big.
Well, you can have this over here in case you need it. So, okay, that's the RPG. That's the big reveal. We're reading the Fatal Rulebook, which I think has a lot of really fun shit in there. However, it's far too dense to cover. If this is such an autistic book that there was easily a good 300 pages for professions and so on. And If people don't know what Fatal is, it's D&D, but it's D&D with less consent. Thank you, Riffadane. Oh God, no. Okay, I'm gonna actually just show you some stuff, and we're just gonna go through this page by page. Like maybe you read a page, I read a page, then you read a page, I read a page, and we'll just do it by screenshot to screenshot.
Well, yep. You tell me.
Read. I want you to read.
Well, I'm gonna try and at least do it in the style of the narrator from Dragon's Crown. So.
What does the Dragon's Crown narrator sound like?
Raptophilia. Over a period of 5 plus 1d100 months, the character experiences recurrent and intense sexually arousing fantasies, sexual urges, or behaviors in involving the act of rape. This causes significant distress or impairment in social, occupational, or other important areas of functioning. This is also called biastophilia. Due to this mental illness, the debauchery, see Chapter 6, Sociality, of this character increases by 50. Whenever a character with raptophilia is near a character who is attractive to them, usually with a charisma of at least 130, they must pass a drive check at TH17 or attempt to isolate and rape the attractive character. For rules on rape, see the section on overbearing in the wrestling skill. See Chapter 8 skills and the intimidation skill.
Yeah. There's skill checks for everything. Right. Oh, great. I wish I actually got you to fucking read this one. I should have started myself off. Europhilia. Over a period of 5 plus 1d100 months, the character experiences recurrent and intense sexually arousing fantasies, sexual urges, or behaviors involving the sexual attraction to urine and acts of urinating. This causes significant distress, you know that part. Due to this mental illness, the debauchery of his character increases by 97. When a urophilic has a full bladder and has the potential to be in a sexual situation, they must pass a drive check at TH20 to control themselves. By the way, I think the TH checks, it's a 1d20. So you need to roll a natural 20.
A big, fat fucking natural in order to get over your piss fetish.
Yeah, it makes sense. Otherwise, they do everything in their power to be able to urinate on a character, and they are extremely satisfied if they can urinate in a character's mouth. A urophiliac enjoys the act of urinating, see Chapter 8 skills, and receives 1d10 skill points SP invested in this skill. So he's,
oh, boy.
Okay, go for this one. Uh-oh! No, maybe we should not. No.
Vaginismus.
Ah!
A recurrent or persistent involuntary spasm of the musculature of the outer third of the vagina interferes with sexual intercourse. This disturbance causes the marked distress and interpersonal difficulty. The muscles spasm with more strength than most would imagine. If this occurs during sex, then both the male and female are interrupted. Those afflicted experience a loss of 1d20 points of sanguine temperament. Obviously, vaginismus only affects females. Fucking transphobia? Tag your transphobia?
Jesus Christ.
Men can have vaginal walls too?
Okay, yeah, I'll make this one a little bit quicker. Vomerophilia. Okay, sexual fantasies involving the sexual attraction to the act of vomiting. Debauchery increases to 100 whenever a vomerophiliac senses vomit. They must pass a drive check at TH20 to control themselves. Otherwise, they begin to sexually touch themselves while fantasizing about the vomit. I guess because that one's quite.
I mean, if you've ever watched Team America, then you know exactly what that's all about. It's just the most erotic thing you could ever imagine. Oh, this one's
perfect.
You get this one.
I think I timed this actually correct. Go.
Zoophilia. Over a period of 5 plus 1d100 months, the character experiences recurrent and intense sexually arousing fantasies, sexual urges, or behaviors involving sexual acts with animals. This disorder is also referred to as bestiality. Zoophilia causes significant distress or impairment in social, occupational, or other important areas of functioning. I can relate. Sometimes, it's like 1 to 30% chance, a character is affected by zoophilia regarding only a particular animal, though it could encompass several fetishes. 31 to 60% of the time regarding 1d6 animals, popular animals for zoophiliacs are number 1, horses, number 2, ponies, number 3, donkeys, number 4, mules, number 5, goats, number 6, dogs, and number 7, pigs. If appropriate, roll 1d8 to determine the animal listed above. Due to this mental illness, the debauchery, see chapter 6 of the sociality, of this character increases by 25. So it's not that bad. It's not that, 25, that's not that bad. I mean, come on.
For one thing, I have to grasp with this guy, because he's not fucking women. There's like a debauchery scale. I think maybe the debauchery scale will show up like later on, so you'll be able to see, you'll be able to see that he's kind of dumb about this. Anyway, sexuality. The preference for a type of sexual partner is sexuality. Heterosexuals prefer the opposite sex and are the social norm. Homosexuals prefer the same sex. Bisexuals enjoy both sexes equally. Did you know? Finally, asexuals prefer to avoid sexual encounters.
Gay men are gay.
No way. Fuck that. I think they're just closeted straight people. To randomly determine a character's sexuality, roll 1d100 and consult the tables below. By the way, elves, because they have a -5, they are the only race going closer to being gay. You know what else it actually proposes? That a female closer with double D cups is much more likely to be straight, but a woman with small breasts is much more likely to be gay.
Well, no, because this is just about, yes, that is true, because it's like from 2 to 3 is homosexual. And yet, like, less than 2 is asexual.
Go on.
It's like you start out with, like, your base modifiers. I imagine that if people really want to, like, truly roleplay, they're going to be rolling for, like, their initial, like, starting sort of stuff, right? And then it's just like, oh, now you have small tits. Now you're gay.
Oh, I just read this. I didn't check this. For the sexuality role, if it's 0405, that's bisexual. But that's 04 to 40 for light elves. So light elves will just fuck everything.
Light elves cannot escape the debauchery of being bisexual. It's an eternal hellscape of just fucking everything that moves. Fucking elves, man.
Anyway, here is can we do a little calculation on the number of births that our pregnant female in our campaign is going to get? Check the offspring number. Please read this.
All right. Offspring number. To determine the number of births per pregnancy, collect 7 10-sided dice, roll 1d 10 million, and consult the following table. From 1, quintuplets. From 2 to 88, quadruplets. From 89 to 7,658, triplets. From 7,659 to 666,161, twins. And from 666,162 to 10 million, single. The fact is that
we needed those dice rolls.
It's so overly complex for what it concerns. It's like you could just have 1d20, but they're trying to implement modifiers that are so ridiculous.
Okay. And also to answer like the guy's question, there's Emo BMX. He said, "Do you roll for penis size?" Yes. You don't just roll for the penis size. You roll for the penis circumference. It's really big. Also for the other organs. Anyway. This is where I found out that the offer was probably not having sex. Debauchery is the willingness of a character to indulge sexual desire. Some characters refuse all sex, while others are willing to do anything. A debauchery score cannot fall below 1 or rise above 100. When role-playing sexual encounters, such as when a character enters a brothel, it is useful to know the degree of debauchery of a character and the whore. Roll 1d100, consider the gender of a character, and consider the following table to determine debauchery. Each character is generally willing to do whatever the result on all acts below it, but refuses to do what is above. Now you can see the fucking table.
All right, let's see. So, I guess it's 1d100, so yep. That's perfect.
You don't have to like read out the numbers because that'll take time.
I guess like go through this like a DM. Like it's just like you enter the tavern with your wench by your side. you ask if the wench can fellate you in front of the patrons. It's like roll 1d100 in order to see what happens. And it's just like, okay, right, let's see. Oh dear. Well, I guess I receive oral sex because I rolled a 3. But, I mean, the fact is that imagine...
Oh, no, wait. Oh, yeah. Okay, gotcha.
Imagine your DM just goes, oh, no. Oh, no. You're urinated on by the patrons of the bar.
But that's... Here's one thing that I don't get. So, oral sex, vaginal sex, mm-hmm. fingering is higher on the debauchery scale. Okay, sure. Oral sex, a gangbang is less debauchery than anal sex.
Here's the thing, right? The roles go from, like, the least debauchery, so refusing all sex, to 99 to 100, which is doing absolutely anything.
No, but here's the thing. But here's the thing. Like, if your debauchery is at like, you know, lower than anal sex, like, no, I won't take it up the butt, but it's like, okay, but what about a gangbang? Yeah, I guess that's okay. You know, I'm a little bit of a modest lady.
Yeah, you know, it's like I rolled a 55, so I'm going to take at least 6 dicks in every hole.
Listen, my debauchery is only 96. I will shit on people. I will not be shitted on. A little bit closer. I will be defecated on.
I will not drink your pee pee. I'm sorry. I just can't do it.
Nice one, fucking bigot.
Drink the piss, bigot.
Okay. Here's a very, very good one. I'll do it as a two thing. Education. Formal education consists of attending a religious school until the human age of 14.
I have to interject. This explains everything. You go to a Catholic school and you're raised like this. Come on, guys.
Of course. There's also little sections on the little social practices at 14. If education is pursued beyond religious school, it is continued at a university. Ken, can you please read this part?
University. Universities are closed to women, but... Only big-brained incels here. Okay. Thoticus get roticus.
Okay, we're going to go through the legal systems of Fatal, because it's different for every different race, and they have different punishments. I basically did a crime and a punishment for several races, which had an interesting punishment. So I'll just do it as like a 2-set, and then I'll give you like a 2-set. So, crime and punishment. Crimes are listed below and defined. The corresponding punishments are organized by race per crime. Adultery. Adultery is voluntary sexual intercourse between a married character and another character different than their spouse, and without the consent of a spouse. Elf, light. Younger criminals are spanked and forbidden from playing pranks and making music for 1d10 years, while older criminals are starved to death. Human, elves, slaves are castrated. Peasants are publicly whipped 2d10 times. Serfs, nobility, or royalty are fined 2d100 silver pieces. The female may be sentenced to work at the local brothel for 1d100 days.
I love this. You just have to imagine your DM just role-playing you in a fucking court of law. It's just like, I sentence you to work at the brothel for 37 days.
Yeah, and this will teach me to cheat.
This will teach you to commit adultery. This will teach you to be a filthy cuck.
Okay. You read this one. I think you'll like this.
Breaking and entering. Breaking and entering occurs when a character forces unwelcome entry into a building or location that has a closed or locked door, window, or other portal. This crime is a more serious version of trespassing. The bugbear. Criminals worth less than 100 SP have their tailbones broken and rectums entered with a sledge. Criminals worth between 100 and 1,000 SP have their tailbones broken. Criminals worth more than 1,000 SP are chastised severely.
So they just get pulled off? Like, don't do it. Essentially, the bugbear law system is a pure laissez-faire capitalism, and, you know, that actually determines your worth. I earn more, thus I am more. So if you actually have a higher worth, it's amazing.
Yeah, this is exactly how it works in real life as well. And Epstein did not kill himself.
Thanks, Ken Ashcorp. Hey, breaking and entering also has like a section for the trolls. Please read that one as well.
Troll, subterranean. The home of the criminal is destroyed and all possessions ruined or stolen. Finally, the criminal is beaten. It's just, regardless of how much you earn, it's just, we'll fucking take you home, we'll take your wife, take your kids, take everything from you, and then we'll just beat you.
I like these ones. Counterfeiting. To counterfeit is to endeavor or succeed in having the appearance or characteristics of something. Most often, counterfeiting relates to false currency. Bugbear. Criminals worth less than 100 SP are killed upon sentencing. Criminals worth between 100 to 1,000 SP are forced into a forge and killed. Criminals worth more than 1,000 SP have their assets liquidated and must watch it all be auctioned.
they just have to sit there. I just find that amazing. Just counterfeiting. Like, oh, I made a very nice painting, but it's not actually mine. It's a forgery. Oh, yeah, worth less than 100. You're fucking dead. You're dead, kiddo. Take that for fucking siphoning off a fake Van Gogh.
Yeah. And it's like the elf punishments all seem to be the same. Dwarf,
it's like,
white.
Yeah, dwarf, white.
Elf, dark. Younger criminals are forbidden sexual relations for 1d10 years, while older criminals are beaten to death by their immediate family. All worldly possessions are confiscated by the government.
Oh, fucking IRS coming and taking everything.
Read this. Debt.
Debt. If a character owes money to another character or their government and is unable to pay their debt, then a character must be punished for the crime of not being able to properly pay their debt.
Okay.
Pay dents. Dwarf, white. I assume this just means dwarves and white people.
No, this is just a white dwarf.
Yes, it's just a white dwarf. This is only for white dwarves. Dwarf and white. The criminal is fined an additional 1d10 GP for each GP owed.
Isn't that like much worse? It's like, oh, you're in debt, you can't pay off your money. You have a fine now that is a multitude bigger.
It's just like, pay your debts. Oh, you can't pay your debts? Pay more debts!
Okay, you're gonna enjoy this one. Please read this.
Troll, subterranean. The criminal is forever forbidden from owning currency. Big nose intensifies.
Incest. Incest is a crime of sexual intercourse or interbreeding between closely related characters. Examples include father and daughter, mother and son, brother and sister, and between first cousins. Bugbear. Criminals who have penetrating sexual intercourse are hanged together on the same noose. Criminals who have sex without penetration, such as frottage, must be publicly tortured until they apologize to their family and community.
It's like, for the crime of touching dicks with your cousin, you're publicly tortured.
You gotta apologize.
And your family watches.
Well, well, only until you apologize. You just gotta keep saying sorry. You can just keep, like, slapping dicks.
I'm sorry, I touched dicks with my cousin. I'm sorry!
Okay, okay, and here's what happens if you're a goddamn troll. Together, the criminals are forced to enter a gladiatorial arena and fight to the death against each other. Okay, okay, you can read murder.
Murder. Murder is the willful, unlawful, and predeterminated killing of a character.
Premeditated. Goddamn, I thought you were English.
Predeterminated. Predeterminated. Fucking, I can't read.
Listen, enjoy. Read Elf Duck.
I am waking up way earlier than
I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Read what black elves do.
Elf Dark. Younger criminals are beaten to death by the family of the victim, while older criminals are beaten to death by their immediate family.
Yep, that's justice.
Just fucking take the rake and beat him.
Pimping. Pimping is the act of pandering or offering a whore to others. The pimp cohabits with a whore and lives off her earnings and often solicits for her. Bugbears. Although bugbears have no legal issues with whores, it is illegal for a husband to pimp his wife. If a husband pimps his wife, then he is publicly chastised.
No, can't do that. I'm sorry. That's not right. No.
Elf, younger. Elf, white, light, whatever. Younger criminals are forbidden from playing pranks and making music for 1d10 years, while older criminals are starved to death.
It's just like, youngers, imagine you're the DM, and you've got this 12-year-old elf pimping out his hot dommy mommy, and you go to court, and the court's just like, no, that's naughty, you're forbidden from playing pranks. 2 years later, they go back into the same court, and it's like, I'm sorry, we're just gonna have to starve you to death.
I wonder if a DM just only does, like, subtly, like, they start the game like, yes, I am an old elf of, like, several hundred years, and it's like, are you sure about that? How about 19?
Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh,
how about 19? How about 19? I recommend 19.
Mate, how about like, 7 years old instead? Like, you'd not...
No, I want to be 7,436.
But with a brain of a seven-year-old, because I have long-term dementia. Anyway, please read this, Ken.
Rape. Rape is an illicit sexual intercourse without the consent of the victim and conducted with force, duress, intimidation, or deception as to the nature of the act. Bugbear. Criminals worth less than 100 SP must wear a chastity belt for 1d10 weeks. Criminals worth between 100 and 1000 SP must wear a chastity belt for 1d10 days. And criminals with more than 1,000 SP are chastised publicly and must apologize to the victim.
Yep.
Just remember, earlier we talked about counterfeiting being fucking the death penalty. But yeah. Rape in this universe, it's absolutely fine as long as you say, I'm sorry.
Well, yeah, I mean, come on, they can... you can continue reading this. This is your same section.
Dwarf, black. The criminal is struck on the erect manhood with a footman's warhammer.
This kills the dwarf.
Ken, I have to tell you, this section is actually just continues going. There is, those are like the little footnotes. This is the human section, and this is part one of two for rape.
Oh boy.
Enjoy. Please read that.
Human. In an average community, an average of 20 rapes occur annually. In 80% of the cases, rapes are committed by between 2 to 15 characters. They force the female's door at night, do not disguise themselves, and either rape the victim in her home, and in the presence of terrorized witnesses, or they drag her through the streets into one of their houses, where they have their pleasure all night long. In 80% of cases, the neighbors do not intervene.
Almost all rapes involve extreme brutality, though they never attempt to wound or kill her. The rapists come from all levels of society. We live in a society, rape text. But the majority are artisans and laborers. Less than 10% of rapes occur by ruffians. In 50% of cases, human rapists are between 18 to 24 years old. The group is comprised, on average, of 6 characters. Only 20% of rapes are committed by a group of more than 9 characters. Half the male youth participate in at least one gang rape. This for everyone. Half the male youth.
Half of the viewers here
have committed a sexual crime. How dare you? Sexual violence is an everyday dimension of community life. There tends to be less in smaller communities, such as hamlets, and more in largest communities, such as cities. If identified, rapists are imprisoned for weeks, though no more than a month. If the victim withdraws the complaint, the rapist is freed immediately.
Yep. That's it, Bonnie.
It's just half the male youth, and sexual violence is an everyday dimension of community life. It happens every day. How can you complain? Just apologize.
Exactly. Anyway, let's go on to a much more severe crime: trespassing.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Less of a crime than breaking and entering, trespassing is to enter illegally upon the land of another character. Bugbear. If a court believes the character trespassed unknowingly, then the criminal is chastised publicly. Otherwise, the criminal has an ankle broken. Dwarf. Black. The kneecaps of a criminal are struck with a footman's warhammer. Dwarf. White. The criminal is fined 1d10 GP. Elf. Black. Young criminals are forbidden sexual relations for 1d10 years. While older criminals, you know the rest. They get killed.
Yeah, it's just a slaying. Forbidden from sex. Naughty, naughty, you can't put your dick in that hole. You can't enter the fairy cave. However... Okay.
Let's be done with these very, very low-key crimes, such as, you know, the act of non-consensual sexual relations. Yeah. Please cover one of the worst. Vagrancy.
One of the worst, I see. Vagrancy. Vagrancy is when a character has no established residence and wanders idly from place to place without legal support. Bugbear. Criminals become a slave to the government for 1d10 years. Oh. Guess I'm going away for 7 years. Dwarf, black. The buttocks of the criminal are struck with a footman's warhammer.
Wait, is there more for vagrancy? Wait, which one is this?
I'm sure that there is. I'm sure, because obviously you have to have elves. Like,
the elf one is like, no, you just can't have sex. It's like, what?
You just can't have. If you're wandering around at night,
if you're homeless, no sex for you. Anyway, witchcraft. Witchcraft, human.
Go ahead.
Witchcraft is the illegal use of sorcery. Human. Sorcery is never legal. A criminal is often raped, then burned alive. What? Were you expecting something nicer for humans?
I was maybe expecting a little slap on the wrist. Maybe an apology would... No. Raped, then burned alive.
By the way, I should clarify, because I looked at the section for witchcraft, and it's like, for the bugbears, it's like, okay, even if you are using unlicensed magic, as long as it was not harmful for people, that's okay. Actually, in kobold society, it was about the same. In troll subterranean society, it was about the same. Human society? Nuh-uh! We fuck a group raper, bro!
It's literally Salem witch trials.
Yeah, it sounds like
you
that.
You use magic, you get fucking burned.
Okay.
Whoring.
Yours. This is whoring. Yours.
Yes. Whoring is when a whore solicits or has sexual intercourse with a character who will pay or has paid for her services. Oh, I know all about this one.
I somehow did not actually grab that segment. Apparently there was nothing good. I just thought it was interesting that it was a crime. And in most places, there is like no penalty.
Yes. I assume in human society, there is a penalty, but it's like a slap on the wrist.
Anyway, here's some recipes, and I want to like you can read this because I didn't give you much. I just want to get your guard down first.
Okay. Recipes. A recipe is a formula for cooking or preparing something to be eaten or drunk. Gingerbread. Ingredients. Breadcrumbs. 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 Cloves. Ginger. Honey. Pepper. And sugar. Instructions. Boil the honey and then stir in the breadcrumbs until evenly mixed. I'm gonna breadcrumbs is just making me laugh too much.
It's okay.
Remove from the heat and then stir in the ginger and pepper. Let it cool, then knead into an evenly distribute the spices. Put it in a box and sprinkle sugar and cloves around the edge. Allow the clove flavor to permeate the bread, but do not eat the cloves with I keep saying cloves. Cloves.
Yeah, don't worry. It's another thing. I can't say my V's and my F's. And my V's and my TH's, sorry. F's and my TH's.
Well, that's a lovely, lovely thing. I will make some gingerbread with my breadcrumb. Keep going. I'll read the next one. You've got my guard down.
Okay, sure.
Rapes in pottage. Ingredients: chicken broth, ginger, onions, rapes, turnips, saffron, salt, and sugar. Instructions: wash, peel, and quarter the rapes, the turnips. Cover the rapes with boiling water. Mince the onions, drain the rapes, and put them with the chicken broth and onions in a pot. Bring this to a boil. Add saffron and seasonings to the potage. Cook until the rapes are soft to the touch with a fork.
I just thought it was nice. They had no reason to actually use that old language, but sure. Anyway, there was like family occupations and stuff like that. What would this be? Oh, yes. Anyway, you can read that as well. It's quite short.
Family occupation. Roll 1d1000 and consult the table for the appropriate occupation by social class. When children become old enough to work, they tend to do the same occupation as their parents.
Anyway, I just saw the roll table. So if you roll
1d1000. Yep. It's like so let's go. So an animal conditioner, which is basically you shovel shit, a baker, a bailiff, a bandit.
How's that a job?
My job is banditry. A barber, a beadle, a beggar, a berserker, a blacksmith, a bladesmith, a brewer, a butcher, a carpenter, a carver, a chambermaid, a cook, a cowherd, a dairymaid, a dock walloper, a druid, a farmer, a gardener, gladiator, a hewer, hierophant, a laborer, laundress, messenger, miller, poulterer, ranger, reeve, shepherd, sorcerer, stabler, swineherd, trapper, and then the final 50. Whore. That's your job.
Ken, I did not notice this before. I screenshotted that because I thought it was funny because, whore. Why is 9/11 sorcerer? Why is 9/11 a sorcerer?
Only sorcerers could make World Trade Center 7 disappear.
Anyway, I don't know if the professions are that entertaining, to be honest. I think you can read like some of the fast ones.
I mean the fact is that most of these are basically like the DM is like, oh, you grow up and this is what happens and blah, blah, blah. And then they roll the D20 to determine what you sort of grow up as. I guess if you start off as an underage character.
Let's not think about that. Anyway, like all to summarize what the jobs are, you get shit like courtesan, and it's like for every customer you suck off, you get like some advancement points, whatever. Anyway, Ken, please read sexual adeptness.
Sexual adeptness. In a sexual encounter, sexual adeptness heavily influences the perception of the other from positive to negative. The amount of pleasure a character derives from a sexual encounter may be determined as follows. For each SP the character invests into sexual adeptness, they may further invest one sexual adeptness point either into cunnilingus, ejaculation, orgasm control, fellatio, or positions. Just, man, imagine role-playing and your DM is just like, oh, come the fuck on. You can't do that position. Yes, I can. I can get into that position and we're going to do a reverse Amazon, okay? We can do it. I'm sure I can. I have enough points. I'm going to roll. It's like, well
you don't just roll, Ken. You don't just roll. It's coming.
You need a big fat natural if you want to get into that position, my friend. Anyway, continue.
Okay. we're going to get into the equations very soon. Don't worry.
Ejaculation. oh boy. Go ahead.
No. You go.
We were both premature on that one.
Okay, go read that one. I'll do
one. Ejaculation and orgasm control. For each SP invested into sexual adeptness, the character may invest in the speciality of ejaculation control, if male, or orgasm control, if female. A male specialized in ejaculation can control his delay until he is ready. A female specialized in orgasm control increases her odds of having an orgasm by one for each point invested. Each female already has base odds for orgasm, woo, which is 1d100. The TH for orgasm is 100 boo.
100 minus boo minus points.
Oh, 100 minus boo minus points invested in orgasm control. Wow. Okay.
Yeah, this is the easy math. We're going to get to the good math soon.
Oh boy, I just imagine the fucking spreadsheet simulator that this is.
A male specialized in ejaculation control increases his ability to delay ejaculation. Each point invested allows a male to delay his ejaculation by 60 seconds if desired. The base time an erect male can delay his ejaculation from initial and continued stimulation is 300 seconds. However, many other factors...
Pussy shit.
However, many other factors affect orgasm control. Consult ejaculation on the next page to obtain SF, scrotum fullness. Subtract SF from 100 to obtain the scrotum emptiness, SE. Divide SE by 100 and multiply it by the base or modified time for ejaculation control. Next, consider the partner's bodily attractiveness and facial charisma skill modifiers. Apply the average during the missionary position. Consider bodily attractiveness twice as important during doggy style. Consider facial charisma twice as important during fellatio. Apply the opposite of a modifier, such as negative 64 becoming plus 64. If a sexual stimulus is novel, then multiply ejaculation control by 0.2. If a sexual stimulus is not novel but boring, multiply... multiply ejaculation control by 2. Finally, if a character is in puberty, then multiply ejaculation control by 0.2. If a character is middle-aged, then multiply ejaculation control by 2. If a character is in old age, then multiply ejaculation control by 3. And multiply it by 4 if a character is venerable. In other words, an old-ass man.
Yeah, it's just a fucking wizard.
Go ahead. You can read these. Fellatio and positions.
Fellatio. For each SP invested in sexual adeptness, the character may invest in the speciality of fellatio. Each SP invested into fellatio represents a new technique, such as a trick with the tongue, lips, suction, etc. During fellatio, the partner's bodily attractiveness counts only half as much as facial charisma regarding the skill check. Positions. For each SP invested into sexual adeptness, the character may invest in the speciality of sexual positions. Each SP invested represents a sexual position known during doggy style, the partner's facial blah 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 blah. You know the rest.
Yeah, half as much. Guys, don't worry, you don't have to keep track of the equations. The equations are gonna come up soon enough.
I mean, if I have like 5 SP, I can suck the balls.
Okay, debauchery discrepancy penalty. Large differences in debauchery between partners will cause a penalty to the impression of sexual adeptness. Subtract one character's debauchery, D2, from the other's, D1, divide the result by 100, and truncate the remainder. Apply the result as a penalty. For reference, the formula is below. So that's D1 minus D2, and then it's to...
Divided by the power of 2,
and then you divide by a...
Yeah, and then divided by 100. I mean, the fact is that you just have to imagine that if the DM of this entire thing, the person who wrote this, ever had sex, that this would be going through their mind the entire time. Like, can you imagine the fucking string of equations in their head just going on?
Okay, you can read this one, because this is like, it keeps building, man.
Oh, check. Concluding the act of sexual intercourse or each sexual position, a character must make a sexual adeptness check concerning the quality of their performance, as does the partner. The higher the roll, the more the character has satisfied their sexual partner. Roll 3d10 and apply the average of all relevant modifiers. Body attractiveness, facial charisma, except in the darkness. All of these are except in the darkness, I guess.
No. Oh, facial charisma. Oh. Please read that
kinetic
one fully.
Kinetic charisma, except in darkness. Contortion SP. In
Ken! Facial charisma! There's facial a whole thing there.
Oh, facial charisma, except in the darkness or with a sack over the head!
Yes, exactly.
No! Contortion SP invested depending on the position and only if debauchery exceeds 50. SP in sexual adeptness. SP invested in the most appropriate speciality such as cunnilingus, fellatio, except and tightness.
Just
tightness
like
all the way at the bottom.
Just anyway,
fucking a sack over the head. No,
Ken, I'm gonna do it. Tightness. For vaginal or anal sex, tightness ratio is a major factor of pleasure. To determine the modifier for tightness, divide manhood circumference by anal or vaginal circumference potential. Multiply the result by 100 and consider it to be base tightness. And use the following parabolic formula. Base tightness minus 80 squared equals minus 4y plus 120. I'm guessing is years. Solve for y. For example, if base tightness is 70, then 70 minus 80, 80 squared equals minus 4y plus 120. It's algebraic. It's an algebraic equation. Y equals 5.
Oh my god, that's absolutely ridiculous. Like, how much long fucking equation do you need to find out whether your dick can enter or not? I mean, this goes back to the bowling ball thing. In the sense that I guess some characters can be raped because it is a daily occurrence in this universe that you'll probably be raped and your neighbors won't give a shit. But I guess this is to roll to check if you're so tight that you. Oh my god! It's a fucking parabolic nightmare. Just look at this. Look at this.
Okay, this is below the equation. You can read that text in the box there, and we can talk about this.
It's like, therefore, the most sexual pleasure is experienced from a fit that is neither too tight nor too loose. The result from tightness is averaged with other modifiers and included in the skill check. Consult the table below to observe the performance of your character and the typical impressions made on the sexual partner. Finally, in the case of multiple partners, a character's satisfaction may be considered either partner-to-partner or averaged for the entire experience. I'm sorry, averaged? One guy might have a 10-inch dick with, like, 5 inches of girth, and the other guy might have a 2-inch micropenis. How fucking, how terrible is that? Averaged?
the tightness, I don't know. Honestly, it's also a Gaussian distribution, I guess.
Yes, I mean, you look at that and just, I mean, it's very tight around, pardon the pun, it's very tight around the top. Like, dysfunctional to below average is just, like, within 4. And then, you know, just average and boring, you know, 2 or 3 positions is not enough. Oh, like, that's terrible. But then you get to like 17 through to like 29, and it's just you go from like your average like sexual encounter to a truly a memory beyond this world.
I would love it if there's actually Quake announcements each time you actually have good sex. Godlike.
Godlike.
Unstoppable.
Monster kill. Killing spree.
Just.
It's time. It's time, my children. Ejaculation. Many factors affect ejaculation, including physical fitness, age, scrotum fullness, SF, and points invested in ejaculation control. The scrotum may accumulate sperm for 2 to 5 days before becoming full. The rate of filling varies with age. From being totally drained, the scrotum fills with sperm in 5 days while in puberty, 2 days for young adults, 3 days for middle age, 4 days for old age, and 5 days for venerable characters. Consider the accumulation of sperm as a percent from 0 to 100. This is scrotum fullness. Each ejaculation drains a percentage of accumulated sperm based on age. Pubescent ejaculation drains 80%. Young adults drain 50%. Middle-aged characters drain 60%. Characters in old age drain 70%. And venerable characters drain 80%. It is uncomfortable for a scrotum to contain 10% or less of its potential sperm. For example, if the scrotum of a young adult is full, then he will be reduced to 50% fullness with the first ejaculation, 25% fullness after the second, 12% fullness after the third, and 6% after the fourth. After 4 consecutive ejaculations, the scrotum of a young adult will feel uncomfortable, and the SF is 6.
After 4 ejaculations, you'll feel uncomfortable.
Okay. Sorry, because this is still like ejaculations.
Oh, keep going. Keep going. My God. Oh, don't fuck. Stop.
This is what it actually goes
off. I'm going to cloom!
The number of ejaculatory contractions is 4 plus 1d6. The distance that sperm is launched on the first contraction is affected by age, scrotum fullness, physical fitness, facial charisma, or bodily attractiveness and novelty. To determine ejaculatory distance, ED, progress through the following. Consider base ED to equal the breadth of the character. Age penalties include negative 25% for pubescent and middle-aged characters, negative 50% for old characters, and negative 75% for venerable characters. Next, divide physical fitness by 100 and multiply ED by the result. When a male ejaculates, the attractiveness of the object he is watching affects his ejaculation. Now, consider whether the male is looking at or imagining a face or body, and divide either bodily attractiveness or facial charisma by 100. Multiply ED by the result. The novelty of a stimulus for the male affects his ejaculation. For example, if a loyal husband only has sex with his wife repeatedly, then while she was exciting at the beginning of a relationship because she was new, she becomes boring in time and decreases his ejaculation.
Oh, no!
A new partner or position may affect this his ejaculation. If this is not the first time the male has ejaculated for this partner, then decrease ED by 1d10%. If a position is not new, then decrease ED by 1d10%. Finally, ED is affected by scrotum fullness. Divide scrotum fullness by 100 and multiply ejaculation distance by the result. Each contraction launches sperm only 1d100% as far as the last contraction. Ken!
Why do we even need to calculate this? You're swallowing.
No! No! Well, how deep it goes into the stomach, I guess. Maybe it has a back blast.
Oh, no! We have to calculate whether I rip her internal organs by the force.
Ken! Ooh. Please read vaginal soreness.
Vaginal soreness. Sometimes vaginal penetration can cause the vagina to be sore after sex. Factors include base tightness and the duration of the vaginal penetration. To determine BT, see tightness above and then multiply BT by the duration of the sexual penetration in minutes. Finally, multiply the result by 0.003. This is the number of hours that the female's vagina is sore.
Amazing. We're getting to the end.
The spells. Yes, this is the spells. Now, this is what Seth introduced me to, which was sort of the crux of the whole thing, because there is spell failure, which is I assume. Now, what's the dice roll for this one? Because obviously it's over 2,400. Is it 1d 10,000 or?
I think this is based on the amount of magic that you have to actually use. I don't know. I did not actually use these calculations. Just know that more difficult stuff, you'll have a higher chance.
Okay.
We will not get to the spell failures yet. I actually did that a little bit too early. We've got the spells for now. After the spells, we'll get to the spell failure, and we'll probably just go through the document together because there's just so many that you can read out.
Yes, I have seen things I ought not to see.
Okay, Kent, can you tell me about the spell against menstruation?
Against menstruation, level 1, magic points 8, discipline water, range the dung of an ass, area 1 woman, duration 1 week. Reference this fucking part. Chant, non, ingredients, an ass's dung. Ritual. You should fumigate a woman with an ass's dung when the menstruation is on her. She stops. Description. Casting this spell will cause a woman to stop menstruating. All of the ass's dung must be used for the spell to take effect. After a week, she will not menstruate. However, within a lunar month, the female will begin to menstruate again, in accordance with her cycle. Why even do it? There's no point. Just wait to have sex. Why would you put the dung of an ass into a woman in order to, why would you do it? There's no point.
Please read that one.
Banish allergy. Level 3, magic points 24. Discipline water. Range touch. Area, one creature. Duration, permanent. Oh, okay, so if I have an allergy to, say, I don't know, like pollen or whatever, I can banish my allergy.
Now, there's now also spells to permanently give people allergies. Okay, you can read this one as well.
Bestow Aeon. Level 7, magic points 56. Discipline, fire. Range, touch. Area, one creature touched. Duration, permanent. Description. Casting this spell causes a target creature to age instantly and permanently by several million years.
the power spikes between these, by the way, is absolutely insane. And you know, conversely, to banish allergy, you need that because there's also bestow allergy.
Oh no. Same again, level 2 spell, 16 magic points. Casting this spell causes a target creature to permanently acquire a random allergy. The target creature must be touched successfully.
Okay, you can read this one as well.
Bestow oh, no! This is disgusting! No!
It lasts for 1d 20 hours. It's a touch spell. You can read the description.
Casting this spell causes a creature to suffer an ingrown toenail, or an ingrown nail, in fact. An ingrown nail is a pain in the finger or the toe. The target creature must be touched successfully. If the target creature resists being touched, then the caster makes a brawling skill. Roll 1d100 to determine whether it is 1 through 50, a fingernail, or 51 through 100, a toenail. Next, determine whether it's on the left or the right hand, 51 through 100, right hand or foot. Finally, roll 1d6 to determine the specific finger or toe. Let 1 equal the thumb or the big toe and re-roll 6s. A creature with an ingrown fingernail will suffer a penalty of 3d10 when making skill checks that involve the use of that hand. I can only imagine that this just means hand jobs and shit like that, because there's no fighting going on in this. This is just sex.
Oh, there is.
Oh, I see. A creature with an ingrown toenail will have their sprint decreased by 1d100%. Otherwise, the ingrown nail is irritating to the target creature.
Very, very interesting. And so, wait.
Oh, God, yeah. In fact, the chat puts it completely specifically. When I finish having sex, I like to touch the female and give her an ingrown toenail. That's just what I like to do. I'm the nail bandit.
I'd like you to read this one as well.
Call lesser being. Oh, so we get to call Mandalore?
Hey.
All right, level 2, magic point 16, discipline air, range 300, I assume feet. 300 feet? Yeah, feet. Area, one creature, duration 2 rounds to an exponential power equal to the level of the caster.
So if you're level 10, then I guess it's 2 by the power of 10. Description: a being of 10 to 20 LP is summoned by the caster to do their bidding. The creature who arrives is determined by the Aedile's discretion, though there is only a 10% chance of failure if a true name is known. Most commonly, these arrive: dogs, kobolds, elves, female humans, big snakes, etc. After the duration of the spell, the summoned being returns to the original code.
Yep. So it's like a lesser being. It just can only call a female.
Just you're sitting in your room, you're reading a book, you know, and then suddenly you're magically teleported to a fucking dungeon. And it's just like, oh yeah, I used call lesser being.
I'm not going to read this whole one, but I just wanted to, like, list you the notes. Call maggots. Casting of a spell summons 1d1000 maggots into the area designated by the caster. Maggots feast only upon dead flesh. If only living creatures are present within the area, then the maggots will crawl over their bodies, eating away only dead flesh, such as dandruff. This is actually healthy for the skin.
Here's the thing: we can solve world hunger by this, because coal maggots, we can eat the bugs.
Well, I mean, we could also solve like the expanding world population, which is not controlled in developing parts of the world. Contraceptive spell area. Would you like to know the range? Touch. Would you like to know the area? A woman's genitals, duration, number of years of sterility according to the number of seeds used.
Oh god, do you have to put seeds in there?
No, I actually read that spell. I can actually tell you what that spell is. You steep these seeds in, like, some kind of liquid, and then you, make, like, a frog imbibe it, and then you make the frog, like, hop around her genitals or something. I don't know.
Basically, the semen demon versus the fluid druid. Imagine if you just roleplayed this going around and making every single other player fucking sterile.
Some guy was asking, where's the restore hymen spell? There's nothing. There's no such thing. However,
You can't restore a hymen. How dare you?
However, Ken, please read the spell.
Develop breasts. Level 2, magic point 16. Discipline earth, range touch, area 1 mammal, duration. Here's the interesting thing about this before I get into the description. Area 1 mammal. Any mammal.
Description:
casting the spell causes the breasts of a target to develop. The target creature must be touched successfully. If the target creature resists being touched, then the caster must make a brawling skill check.
Spell has a table. The spell has a whole fucking table. Now go read the rest here and look at the table.
This spell must be cast on any mammal, male or female, young or old. The effects of the spell are to increase the size of the breasts of the target creature. In fact, the breasts will increase the equivalent of 1 cup size. However, there is no guarantee that they will be perky. For instance, the nipples may aim at the ground. If male breasts are developed, then the male will not gain muscle nor breast milk, but the fatty deposits of the chest will augment. This causes a reduction in 3 in the bodily attractiveness stat. Others may be more likely to mock the male's breasts. Oh dear. If female breasts are developed, then she is likely to gain significantly more sexual attention. Below are modifiers to bodily attractiveness based on the new cup size. This is ridiculous. This is absolutely ridiculous. It's like anything. Oh, double D is minus 5?
What?
Double D is minus 5, triple D is minus 10, and anything over a triple D is minus 15.
Okay, well, it would be fair enough, unless for, like, big mommy milkers fetishes. But it's like, what? A B cup is more attractive than a C cup? What world does he live in?
I don't understand this. Like, and especially if you go from, like, an A cup to a D cup. Like, imagine you go from an A cup to a D cup, it's just plus 5. It's just plus 5.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm completely forgettable. You can... I hate females. sorry, that came out of nowhere.
Clip that, and that's exactly what he thinks of you, chat.
Anyway, let me tell you at least a fun spell. Defenestration, level 1. One creature.
Oh boy, defenestration.
Casting of a spell causes a creature or object seen by the caster to be ejected out the nearest window. If there is no window within 100 feet, then the spell fails. The target will feel an invisible force. The force will push them toward the window at a rate of 100 feet per round, regardless of resistance. If a character has room, their only hope is to run away from the force and, of course, avoid the window.
Avoid the window. Just, it fails if the room doesn't have a window. Just, it has to be out a window. It can't just be out anywhere, but anyway, this is something I do on a daily basis. Ejaculate blood. Level one, the area, testicles of the touched target creature. So you can do it to yourself or you can do it to anybody else. The target creature must be touched successfully. If the target creature resists being touched, then the caster must make a brawling skill check. The spell only works on males. Only on female ejaculation, a myth. Upon successful contact, the next time the target creature ejaculates, normal sperm will not spew forth from its manhood, but blood.
Conversely, I liked it because this goes a little bit deeper. Wait. Is that?
Oh, I'm sorry, chat. There is no anti-autism spell.
Conversely, ejaculate poison. The target creature must be touched successfully, yada yada. Upon successful contact, the next time a target creature ejaculates, normal sperm will not spew forth from his manhood, but poison. The entire load of magical poison will cause one LP or IP or LP of poison damage per caster level to whatever it touches. If the semen is ingested by a female, she must pass a health check of TH14 or die. So you can... Hey, bro, like, let me touch your testicles. Wait, did you cast a spell on my testicles? No.
No, I just wanted to touch. Just wanted to touch testicles.
Oh, and the name of a game. You can read the name of a game.
The name of the game, Fatal. Level 10, magic points 1,800. I assume this is incredibly hard to cast. Casting this spell causes all life to instantly die on the current world of the caster. This cause of death is inexplicable. Fatal is the most powerful spell ever mentioned, and so far, it has never been cast by a mortal.
If only there was an anti-autism spell.
there is no anti-autism spell. I mean, there's an anti-allergy spell, but no anti-autism. You can't touch somebody's testicles and take away their autism. I'm sorry, it doesn't
work.
Okay,
well,
like
let's get to better spells. Erection spell, please tell me how. This is a ritual.
Wouldn't this just be on touch anyway? I mean, for an erection, discipline air, range touch, area one manhood, duration 2d 100 minutes. Oh, wow. That's pretty good. I mean, 2d 100, I mean, it could be for 2 minutes. It could be for several hours. Ingredients, woad plant, wine, and pepper. The ritual, boil the woad plant in a pot and grind them up in wine with pepper. Smear it on your genitals. If you wish it to relax again, provide with a decoction.
Decoction.
Decoction. Fucking... fuck me. This game will fuck me, I'm sure. Description. Casting this spell causes a limp man... causes a limp man... No, let's just go with limp man. It just causes a limp man. It's just your leg's a bit gimp. Here, I can touch your testicles and make your leg good again. Casting the spell causes a limp manhood to become a blue-veined throbber. Though ejaculation will occur normally, there will be no refractory period afterwards. It will remain throbbing for the duration of the spell unless a decoction is provided.
By the way, this is not actually a completely fake ritual. Woad pigment will do that to a penis. One thing I should mention, woad is the things that the Celts put on them when they made war paint, and it's actually carcinogenic.
That's amazing. As we all know, carcinogens cause cancer. Everything causes cancer. But at the same time, can you imagine smearing that on your body and just being the hardest motherfucker in the North? Scotland forever!
Well, in that regard, I guess I have to do this in the Scottish one. For swollen testicles, level T, magic points, 16, discipline, fire, range, 1 mile. Area, one set of testes. One set of testicles, yeah.
Duration, 3 minutes to an exponential power equal to the level of a caster. Chant, caster, fab, fab. It sounds like Scottish fab, now.
Caster, fab, fab.
Tiokfot arla. Ingredients, a cord from a coin bag. Ritual, type the ingredient and of each note speak the chant. Description, casting a spell causes a testes of a male envisioned by the caster to swell to the point of causing discomfort and even pain. For the first minute, actually feels pretty good and makes a male horny to have full testes. Beyond the first minute, however, discomfort predominates and it becomes difficult to walk.
It's like you're walking down the street and somebody just comes up to you and they're just like, caster, thab thab. Your balls begin to fill with cum. Delicious cum. But they keep growing and there's too much cum. It's just coming out of your urethra. You're just ejaculating all over yourself. Fucking mental, mate. Fucking mental.
I'm just trying to have a quiet Sunday stroll. Trying to come just, down to the bet store. I'm trying to go to the bookies.
I'm trying to go down to the bookies and he's just touching my testicles and making me shit blood.
Listen, mate, I don't think the bookie's an actual bookie. I think he's a fucking sorcerer. I saw him with pentagrams and shit like that.
Oh, honestly, he touched me testes once and I just think he's a fluid druid.
Listen, mate, how did every fucking doctor in this place get replaced with a proctologist?
They keep touching my anus and I keep shitting blood. It's just not right. It's not right.
All right, okay, let's continue. I guess you could try it with the same accent, since we're going with this theme.
Force fart, level 1, magic points 8, discipline earth, range 50 feet, area 1 creature, duration 2 seconds to an exponential power equal to the level of the caster. Description, casting this spell causes the target seen by the caster to experience an accumulation of gas in their rectum, forcing them to fart. As the caster increases in level, the target will have to fart for a longer duration. Imagine you're a level 27 fluid druid. You force fart and they can't stop farting for fucking 7 hours.
Anyway, I can't do this in the whole thing. Force inferiority complex. Casting the spell causes the target to feel inferior to the caster. For the duration of the spell, the target creature will experience a 25% reduction in drive and will resent the caster. If the target primary temperament of a creature is choleric, then there is a 25% chance that the target creature resorts to violence against the caster. The Adal may modify the chance due to circumstances. If a secondary temperament of a target creature is choleric, then there is a 75% chance that the target, if sentient, will badmouth the caster. By the way, choleric, sanguine, yes, he's got the fucking four humors in his rule book as well.
Oh yeah.
Anyway, let me get you another. What the fuck is this?
This entire thing's just a wee joke. It's just a wee joke.
Listen, mate. Can you do the next one? In the same accent, yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Yeah, all let's right. See what we got up here. Listen, mate.
Let's go. Let's fucking go. Level 10, magic points 1,000.
No, mate, say the name.
I'm going to say it. Don't worry. Discipline fire, range 100 miles or the entirety of Poland. Area. 10-mile blast radius. Duration, instantaneous. This is Greater Holocaust. Description, casting the spell causes an incomprehensible burning damage. The caster must choose a central point from within the range. From the central point, a fiery blast will explode violently and implode again within one round. Anything within the area is subjected to 4D100 times 100 IP or LP. It is likely that only ashes will remain. Vegetation will not grow in this area for one millennium. The explosion will be heard and felt for up to 100 miles away. Well, obviously, we now know that the Holocaust is a lie because vegetation will not grow in this area for one millennium. Poland's thriving! How? Oh, it's the Holocaust all over again!
Ken, you can't say that on the fucking D live stream. I gotta have to shut down this goddamn anti-Semite. No, I'm actually gonna correct you. We suffered greatly. Although my family that was actually incarcerated in Germany, they actually had a better time. They actually got their land back.
Pay dents.
Okay. And I'll do the other one. This is not as powerful. Level 9, magic points 270, pretty easy. Discipline fire, 1 mile blast radius, range 50 miles. Yeah, lesser holocaust. Yeah, nothing big.
it's nothing big.
No vegetation.
It's just a wee holocaust, mate. It's just a wee holocaust.
Listen, like, no vegetation will grow in this area for one century. I guess unless you replant new soil.
That's not bad. It'd be right good now. And you could go to Poland. Then obviously it was a lesser holocaust. That's it.
Right. Okay. Enough. I need to get away from this shit. It's fucking hard to keep you intact. I can't believe you're so politically correct.
Yes, I know. I'm just trying to maintain a balance of edge and society. And inside me are two wolves, and one quotes statistics about crime from the FBI. And the other says the N-word, and I am an epic gamer.
Okay, let's just assume that you're just a professional actor. Okay, you can read impotence, just normal voice, whatever you like.
Impotence. Casting this spell causes the target creature to become impotent. The area is one creature, the range is just the touch, so you have to touch somebody. The degree of impotence is affected by the level of the caster. The spell does not affect females. Once again, tag your transphobia. Come on. If the target creature must be touched, successfully. If the target creature resists, brawling check, blah, blah, blah. The caster level, you can make it limp for minutes. However, if you are over level 14, the manhood will be limp permanently.
The thing is, like, 13 to 14 is already pretty bad. Like, 11, 12, limp for 1d10 years. 1d10 decades for 13 or 14.
It's like
it may as well
life.
Be permanent. It may as well be fucking permanent. Look, even I don't like the fucking rules of this.
I mean, can you imagine like the lesser holocaust is like a witchcraft spell, and so it's like if a human does it, it's bad, but if an elf does it, a slap on the wrist and no playing pranks.
No pranks for you. Anyway,
intestinal. No pranks for you, little elf boy. Now go on your merry way.
Intestinal reef. Casting the spell causes a creature's intestines to emerge from their rectum and encircle the neck of your owner. The target's intestines will strangle them with a strength equal to the caster. Even if a target overcomes their animated intestines, they are usually bewildered for the rest of their lives, and defecating is uncomfortable at best. The caster must be able to see the target creature at all times and maintain concentration.
Well, considering this is at a range of 500 feet, I have to say this is definitely how Epstein died.
Oh, we've got the Jesus spell. I thought this was relevant because somebody asked me how many loaves of bread did I eat.
Oh, wow. Multiplication of loaves and fish. Level 4, magic points 32, discipline water, and range is touch. And the area is a quantity of loaves and fish. So you need an actual quantity. You need your fish and you need your loaves. Casting the spell causes any loaves of bread and fish before the caster to multiply by 500 times. Hence, one loaf of bread would become 500 loaves of bread. Only bread and fish may be multiplied. The bread and fish must each be lighter than 5 pounds.
Yeah, there's some normal spells in between here. Ooh, you might like this one.
Oophagus. It is an oophagus. Level 2, magic point 16, discipline earth, range touch, area 1 creature, duration permanent. Description: casting this spell causes the digestive system of the touch target creature to be permanently changed. From now on, the target creature must eat eggs to survive. Food other than eggs will be regurgitated. Just fucking smash mouth, eat the eggs. I cast oophagus on you.
Oh, Jesus, it reminds me of that fucking green text where, like, a guy was like, oh, yeah, if I found, like, a prostitute, I'll just bring her back into my place and serve her a big bowl of eggs.
That's beautiful. That's the perfect image.
Wait, where's the egg fort? Where's the egg fort from the CK?
Oh, yes! The egg fort! Fucking yes! Egg fort! Egg fort! Egg fort! Egg fort!
You're so autistic.
Yes! Oh, I remember when this was in the 4chan Cup as like a 3D model. The egg fort.
Yeah. I saw that. I saw the goal for that. That was very, very amazing.
Thank you. Thank you, Smash Mouth.
Okay, wait. Ooh. Okay. Sorry, I'm just having troubles, like, sorting these.
Seth unleashing his inner Mbeke.
Okay, Oroanal, level 4. Permanent. Casting this creature causes one orifice of a touched creature to function as both an anus and a mouth. For example, in nature, a starfish is oroanal. It eats and defecates through the same orifice. The target must be touched successfully. If a target creature resists being touched, then the caster must make a brawling skill check. If a caster successfully touches the creature, then either 1 to 50% anus or the 51 to 100% mouth becomes an oroanal orifice.
I see where this is going.
If the anus becomes an oroanal orifice, then the mouth will become sealed shut. Defecation will occur as usual, but food must be shoved into the anus where it will be digested. If the mouth becomes an oroanal orifice, then the anus will become sealed shut. Eating will occur as normal, but defecation emerges from the mouth.
I'm hanging with my homies. You know, we're all having fun. He goes to pat me on the back, and suddenly I start shitting out my mouth.
Okay, so I just... somebody said you're cringe, you get to read more.
I'm cringe? Fortunately,
it's
based. Perpetual orgasm, level 5, magic points 40, discipline earth, range touch, area 1 creature. Duration permanent. Casting this spell requires the target creature to be touched successfully, and if the target creature resists, blah blah blah. If successful, then the target creature will orgasm without end and for eternity!
And it continues. It continues.
As good as a never-ending orgasm sounds, no creature is capable of remaining alive while experiencing a perpetual orgasm. For the first 1 to 2 minutes, the effects of the spell will seem like the greatest blessing to the target creature. Thereafter, survival depends on the sub-ability of health. Every minute after the initial 1 to 2 minutes necessitates a health check. The check must be passed to remain alive. Initially, the health check is TH14. However, the TH increases 2 per minute, the target creature will die of a heart attack. However, even after death, their corpse will continue to orgasm. To an observer, it will seem as though the corpse convulses from the hips. Casters often chuckle, thinking that if you have to die, what a way to go.
That's I mean, honestly, some of these spells, they do seem not very, very well balanced, to be honest.
Just your corpse will just continue orgasming even after you're dead. That's fucked up.
Oh, okay. There's another one. I don't want to fucking show that one. Fuck that. There was one where it's like, hey, you basically curse a woman and she will just basically either give stillbirths or deform children.
Oh,
hey, that's
God.
Fun. That's fun.
That's fun. That's fun for a Sunday morning stream.
Yeah, okay,
we've been on this for an hour and a half, you do realize
Yeah,
right?
I thought this stream would actually be earlier, but let's read, like, a few more. There's one which will give you, like, a Cro-Magnon jaw. Please read this one, and I'll read the one after that.
Oh my god. Spermatozoa rejuvenation. Area. 2 testicles. Duration until the next ejaculation. Description. Casting this spell causes the full rejuvenation of a pair of testicles, if fondled gently by the caster. The target creature must be touched successfully and blah 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 brawling skill. When balls are this full, the overabundance of sperm increases the drive of the target by 2d10. Choleric temperament by 1d100, and they may also experience restlessness as well as perpetual sexual thoughts. If and when vaginal penetration occurs within one day, the use of the ramrod necessitates a roll of 1d100. The mounter is 95% likely to impregnate the female, regardless of species. Due to the misuse of the spell, many new races or species may be bred.
Thank you, thank you. Sorry, people were giving me a panic scare because they said like the stream might have like stopped for a sec. Sorry.
No, that's perfectly okay.
No.
Doing alchemies with your homies is sus as hell. Fucking sus.
Bruh, let me just rejuvenate your ball sack, bruh.
Let me just touch your balls so the next thing you come into will 100% give birth.
Oh, it's like in real life. Do you know what docking is? Does anybody know what docking is? Ken, do you know what docking is?
Well, I know what symmetrical docking is.
Ken, can I just explain what docking is? It's like when you out of sperm and you like go to your homie. It's like, yo, I gotta go for round three with my girl, but I ain't got no sperm. He's like, don't worry, homie, you're just docking me. And it's like, you know, you go into his foreskin and you get a dock going, and he gives you like a transfer. Listen, he gives you a recharge. He gives you a homie charge, and then you can go in and, you know, nut your girl.
Seth, you sound like you've done this on many occasions.
No, I just know what docking is. I know the principles. Come on.
You know the principle. I think you've researched this very thoroughly.
Look! Shut up! I'm gonna read Spermicidal Sphere.
Oh no!
Spermicidal Sphere. Casting this spell allows the caster to choose the location of his sphere. Everything within this sphere at the time of casting will instantaneously lose any and all reproductive fluids for 1 hour. Affected males lose 2d10 drive for the duration of the spell, and unless under duress, feel compelled to sleep. So this is a sperm drain sphere.
Just, here's the thing, right? Just imagine that you're going into this game wanting a sexy, sexy time, etc., etc. But this one fucking Spurg Lord to your left is just sitting, giggling, just chuckling. And you know, the first time you get into the bedroom with a woman, he's going to cast that spermicidal sphere, the 10-foot radius, and he's just going to be like, ooh, your balls hurt, do they?
Okay.
You could
read like these little things, because that's actual stuff on your character sheet. I think that's a good little thingy.
So yeah, this is my character sheet. My manhood length, my manhood circumference, my anal circumference potential, my vaginal circumference potential, and my vaginal depth potential. My areola diameter, my nipple length, my cup size, my tongue size, my hymen resistance, my areola hue, my foot size, my fist circumference, my head circumference, and my handedness. I mean, you know, it's all of these things make the perfect little character.
And I think to not let to keep like going this for much longer than it has to be, let us get to the final part. So when you fuck up spells, this is a part that I've been meaning to get to for a long time. So Ken, there are 2,400 different effects, I believe, that can happen if you fail spell casting.
And reminder, spell casting, anything under like 2,400 or something like that is like increases the chance of a spell failing. So this could be a common occurrence.
Okay, so you can read that one.
Number 8. The caster gives birth to a clone through their manhood / vagina. The new clone is 1d6 levels higher. Just imagine, just the caster gives birth to a clone through their manhood and vagina, and the new clone is just better than them. It's just better than me. Just fuck. It's like I birthed a new god.
He came out from my penis. He basically made my penis hurt, and now he is just straddling around.
He's just better than me in every way. 1d6 levels higher. He's just better than me. I can't compete.
Yeah, why don't they just kill like the original now and just make the clone have that same effect? I'll read these. 24, mm-hmm. Target's genitalia are swapped with random party member. 25, caster's genitalia grow by 2d20% in size.
I just imagine those flaps. Imagine those flaps growing 2d20% in size.
Caster sperm becomes magical. It can impregnate anything and make half-breeds.
Yeah, that's kind of like the other one that we saw. That's basically the same thing.
Caster is able to shoot flames out of her ass 1d100 feet at will. 1d6 LP damage.
Oh, that's amazing. Like, that's a spell fuck-up. I would say that's an ultimate win. I would say that if you got that, that's fantastic. That's just another weapon in your arsenal.
I think... Go.
Number 129. The caster does nothing but artistically draw dragons for 24 hours. Number 130. The target develops asthma. Number 131. The nearest party member becomes an alcoholic. Number 132. The target becomes a whore. Just you touch your homie's balls just to give him a recharge, but you fuck up the spell, and now he's a man whore. How could you?
Okay, now this is 10 minutes of this nutty shit. So I'm gonna, here's a fatal book again, just for your link, and I'll tell you the page where the random spell effects are actually starting. It is. 863.
By the way, for people who don't understand this, this is 977 pages long. This is a fucking troglodyte level book here. Like, we are talking severe autism has caused this to come into our world, and nothing can take it away.
It's not all the pages afterwards. There's also, like, little things of ingredients. But let's say that the spell effects, that's most of them, these ones. So what we're going to do here, because there's no way that I can just keep snippeting them out. Go from 863, and if you just see something you like, please just read it out for the audience.
Number 68, the caster's blood becomes a random poison, now immune to all poisons. How are these bad things? Number 95, a gerbil pops out of the target's ass.
Caster gains a fecal breath weapon, 30 inch long, 30 inch diameter, 3 times a day. It results in -3 TH for 1d4 rounds.
And between all this, number 138, the caster becomes extremely arrogant. The caster becomes a serial rapist. Oh dear. Number 169, the caster buys a tiara and wears it everywhere.
Oh, and also number 69, since somebody asked, it's just a itching frenzy. But there's one which is really nice. Number 65, the next hypothetical statement said by the caster immediately becomes true.
Your dick has an eye and it can see truth. Like, what was that one?
Your eye grows, your penis grows an eye at the end of it, and it can actually tell a truth or a lie once per day. But may I tell you, number 85, two gay ogres appear in a 30 meter radius and begin to butt plug as if there is no tomorrow.
Oh god. Caster's buttocks are singed for 1d4 LP instantaneously. Just, my ass is on fire.
Number 90. Next time caster defecates, their intestines fall out of her ass, though still loosely attached. 91. An illusory disembodied 3D 10-inch long schlong appears and tries to fuck whoever has the most LP in 500 feet.
In a 500-foot radius! If you're near the king, it will try to fuck the king! I like this one. Number 82. Number 82. Every time the caster performs a magical action, they say, "I love you, you little whore."
What?
They have to say that every time they cast an action. That's it. The caster can now hear earthworms crawling. This is all amazing. This is just absolutely amazing. The caster can now play the flute, pretty much just before that, the target is instantly teleported 50 feet away in a random direction.
201. Caster now prefers mating with farm animals and is now a zoophiliac.
Caster develops a fetish to drink her own sperm once at each meal. We don't have to say the numbers. Everything is actually believable here. We don't have to make anything up anymore.
Honestly, yeah, like, they have to drink their sperm once at each meal. That's just a regular European thing. The semen pipelines, they're flowing very vociferously now.
Somebody did a good joke in chat, by the way. 126, the average YouTuber. Caster becomes flexible enough to kiss her own ass. Wait, 200? 200? Somebody said 200. Caster tries to fist fuck the next sleeping female scene, no matter when or where. 199. Oh. The caster only wants to have sex with preteens!
Oh, dear. Oh, no. No, that hebephilia. No. No, sir.
Oh, no. Yeah. Wait. I'm actually dialing these from chat. Caster thinks the nearest... Oh, no. 103. Caster develops a foot fetish. One of the worst.
Just all you have to do is recite Quentin Tarantino 3 times.
What's 199? The caster only wants to have... shit.
Yeah.
Sorry.
218. The caster gains the ability to fart arpeggios up to 240 beats per minute in 16th notes.
Oh my god.
And 220. The caster must play with his cock and balls in front of 10 plus characters once a day, or acquire a random insanity.
Caster literally shits a brick instantly. 203. Yep. The next female with charisma over 120 orgasms upon seeing the character. Wait, what's 94? Caster's pubic hair grows 10 feet in length instantly.
The caster's asshole dilates to 9 inches in circumference every time they smell rain.
What?!
Caster vomits 96 times in a row, all within 2 minutes.
Wait, I think I can actually dial these 96 times in a row, all within 2 minutes.
It's just
Caster immediately below that. Caster immediately wants to give head to the next axe in sight, even if in battle.
Just fucking blow that axe, my friend. Blow that axe. I mean, number 232, casters and targets head fall off and they die. That's it. It's game over.
Oh, 257, the nutsack of a caster swells to 10D1000 in volume for 3D 3 days. But if female, her eyebrows disappear.
Oh my god. The next, 234, the next female at whom the caster looks at will queef 6D12 times in a row. And loudly.
Great. Amazing. Okay. 234. Okay.
241. The caster develops a phobia of old wenches. 239. The caster sticks their finger in their ass and then sniffs it for 2d4 rounds.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, that's the one. 253. Eyeball appears on the caster's cockhead. It can determine truth/falsity of one statement once per day.
Are these girls of age?
Yes, I feel like they're of age.
Jesus. Oh yeah, that's the one. Next time caster poops, the turd comes alive, attacks the caster. Plus 1 TH for 1 LP, B damage, CA 13. Yeah, it's the stats.
Jesus Christ.
Target turns into a female who has an obese torso and skinny limbs.
Oh god, it's Attack on Titan. That's it. Just think Attack on Titan, they just turn into the Titans. Oh,
Jesus,
no.
Some of these are so fucking horrendous.
Yeah, the defecation of the caster is forever white in color. Just no reason. The caster accidentally casts Recipe for Death. All of these are absolutely fantastic. And there are just pages and pages of these.
Caster has an inexplicable love for ogres. Adile decides how the ogres are loved. Adile is basically the dungeon master.
Just... some of these are just random. Every time the target lies, their manhood/nipples grow an inch.
Oh, Jesus.
Just, wow.
Caster transmogrifies into a cock of 1d8 plus 3 inches for 2 rounds. Pass health check of TH21 or die. I'll remember about the hentai pill. Don't worry about that.
Look at 332 onwards.
What? Oh, yeah, that's a lot.
this is just, like, all of those are just branding. Like, you are just branding and you worship a god.
I would love it if they had, like, one which is, like, for modern times. You just have to, like, name your favorite goddamn brand. Fucking Blizzard Activision each time you come.
I am gonna say this. I'm gonna say this. If any of you are dungeon masters out there, use this. Not as, like, a spell failure thing, but just the fucking ingeniousness of some of these. Like, 415, the caster curses every god they can think of before every meal. Like, just... I mean, it's fine, because all you do is you're just giving your party members just these random terrible things, and remember, you have to sit them down for a meal at some point, and they just have to do it. They just have to do it in front of you. It's like, the target creature vomits whenever they mention their god. It's just like, I think, I love Jesus.
I think the whole thing is, if they probably, like, made this, like, a more serious actual, like, rule book and just kept, like, a lot of the crazy shit, I think it would actually be, like, a pretty normal game you could actually play with people. But yeah, I will say, 451, lightning strikes all characters in 1d 100 feet who disagree with the next thought of a caster.
Oh my god, that's literally Tumblr's favorite spell.
The target's manhood slash vagina can think, speak, and must eat to survive. Is that also Tumblr of a spell?
I mean, that's basically all of them. I just mean everybody on the website, that's basically all of them. Just so many of these are absolutely crazy. 450 time is...
Oh my god, the character... The 568, the character caster acquires an anal fetish for Anakim or bugbears, dwarves, elves.
Yeah. Oh my god. The target creature will forever refuse to trim their fingernails and toenails. I love so many of these. Read 666, it's good. Okay. The nearest employer treats their employees like they actually want to value them for 1D 100 days.
I wonder if this is a reference. This might be a reference. This is like a breaking the fourth wall here. He might have been working at, like, Target.
Probably. He works at Kroger. He's every day he goes into Kroger.
Oh, yeah. So there's two, which is quite nice. It's like, okay, a living kobold fetus emerges from the rectum of a caster, 630, and conversely, 622, a dead kobold fetus emerges from the rectum of a caster.
I mean, 620, a dead elven fetus emerges from the rectum of a caster.
No way, that's a lot more funny.
you shit out a small elven boy. No pranks for you.
555, Yeller yells, I am the Kang of Kangs. 556, the caster collects semen from slaves!
The penises of peasants, the noses of nobles, the livers of ladies, the brains of barons, the dicks of dukes, the kidneys
661, the next male to ejaculate will launch for sperm 1d 1000 feet. Any obstruction takes 1d 10 LP damage. That's actually equivalent to getting cut by a battle axe.
Yes it is. In the nearest community, children rule, and all adults are slaves for 1d 10 days. The youngest is king.
Well, what happens? Listen, okay. 662 happens. What if 665 also happens? Every character in the nearest community has an orgy that lasts for 3 days. I think this is a game that's just meant to lock you up.
The nearest public speaker screams, I'm full of shit. Why? Oh my god. 674, the caster must force broccoli into each ear or they become irate and scream until they can.
Jesus Christ.
The
caster tries to perform self-anal fisting for 1d10 hours and refuses to give up.
Just, some of these are amazing. Yeah, 670, the nearest master must attempt to rape their favorite apprentice and the caster knows it.
Oh, there's a lot for, like, target skin changing colors. And then 767 is like, target skin turns white. Real white, mom.
Real white.
Oh, there's a bunch of hallucinations.
Oh no, 754 is basically all of us. The caster loses all emotions. They only do things on command. No facial expression ever again. Get back in your cagey, wagey.
Oh, a lot of V's are actually boring. No. V's are actually like, you is just actual miscast. It's just if a low one seem to have like shit.
Yeah, it's yeah, like the lower ones are just kind of like random ones that are just there. I mean, then you get to like 1,162, and the target is afflicted with a suicidal mania for 2 hours. You know,
Jesus.
Target pleads to the nearest enemy. It's all the caster's fault. He did it.
Caster
carves one. A caster carves 100 times on the next tree scene. My name is George, and I eat shit for breakfast.
1788. Target creature acquires zoophilia.
Acquires, of course. Yeah, and there's a lot of accidentally castings. Target creature forever experiences the orgasm of their sexual partner, and the partner does not feel it.
Jesus.
Yeah, just so many of these. Target creature gives a vulgar display of power with their mouth for war by yelling, "I'm fucking hostile."
Oh, I've got one which actually could be great for the incels.me episode. Erotophobia, fear of female genitalia.
Fear of females, man.
Sorry, I went down to the phobias. Why does he have to list all the phobias?
Oh no, number 2000, the very last one, is just very sad.
Caster is ostracized by those about whom they care.
Oh, that's and like all the ones before, like the caster is depressed. Like, this just turns very, very dark right at the end, and you can kind of see what the writer of Fatal was all about with this.
Jesus, wait, this is like some breaking the fourth wall. Caster suffers confusion for 5 years. Caster is happier than they should be. Caster cares deeply for the wrong character. Roll to determine who in the vicinity. Cat appears before the caster and they adore each other. The name of a male cat is Hades. Caster is depressed.
Like I said, this is just life.
I think this is actually a troubled man at the end of the day.
From 1995 to 2000, like that's just the really troubled scrawlings of a madman.
Listen, man, 1995 to 2000, Caster suffers confusion for 5 years. It's 5 entries.
Yeah.
From that point on.
And I guess like each one is just a year of his life.
Jesus. Well, there's
I mean, you know what? If I wrote Fatal, I would also be ostracized. So, you know, you kind of brought this on yourself, mate.
Well, at least we end this on like a very somber note.
We do indeed. Though, if I can make one request of the chat, I know on DLive that you can spam Kalena hitting that nut button. It's like I just get a lot of enjoyment out of Rice Nat's girl. Like Kalena is pretty great. So spam Kalena hitting that nut button if you can.
Wait,
because
who's that?
It's you'll see it in chat in a couple of seconds. It's
right.
It is a girl. It is an elven slutty girl named Kalena, who is in one of my songs.
How do you know all this shit?
She's in one of my songs. Like she's the elf on the right in We're Shameless.
Okay, I'm not finding anything for brunette touching Latina station. Her brunette cock and pics.
Well, it's like you gotta spell it right.
It's fine. We'll you'll show me this later. I'm sure I will,
and I'm sure that you'll love all the art of her.
So I guess I gotta give this statement before we do like to the final part. I wonder if like actually listen. So this is I don't want to do the streaming thing for a regular thing anymore, because of course it takes time away from making the videos. Streams will still happen when they do. It'll be nice. Let's savor the nice times we have together. Also, the fact is, to make anything entertaining, there has to be sort of material. We don't want to end up getting to a stage where there's no material and you just turn on the fucking camera. Ooh, thank you. I know this shouldn't be on stream, but that's pretty fucking hot.
Oh, it's fine. It's censored.
Yeah. It's, anyway, yeah, because if we have stuff to show, we'll show it. And I think one thing that we can do with a second channel, if that ever like actually materializes, we will bring in famous boys like Ken, and we will read some terrible garbage and maybe put it together.
When I was originally pitched this, I was just like, oh no, he's gonna have me read like terrible fanfic. Here's the thing, it's just like terrible fanfic gives you stuff like Sonic High School, which you should all go check out and enjoy on Internet Historians Incognito.
Fucking shill. Jesus Christ.
Just start a fatal campaign with Ken and others. Oh, God.
So I just wanted to tell people like how it is. We got our hentai money. I'll make a poll for like what kind of hentai we would get funded with the money that we got. It's been rather nice. It's been very cool with the crowd and so on. And here's the thing. If there's a new stream contract from DLive, then maybe there'll be like another 4 streams or something like that. Mm-hmm. But I wanted to do a very nice ending for this stream. And we've delayed this for far too fucking long. I guess you get to witness this as well. Depending on everything fucking works. So, I live near the center of a city. I gotta tell you some stuff. I live near the center of a city, and one of the main things that I had to deal with when I got here, like very early on, is that about 1 to 3 p.m. during the day, okay, sometimes there's like Indians who are like praying to Krishna like really, really loudly. I don't mind that. They have scuffed loudspeakers. That's okay. But sometimes there's a really fucking annoying pastor who comes in. Not even a pastor. He's just some preacher that wants people to buy his fucking book. And he's just this dude who nobody likes. He comes in with a fucking subwoofer sound system that fucking blows out the terrain around him and just keeps preaching about the law of God. Now, I would never fucking show my face because I don't want to fucking die and get shot. However, I want to show you guys my pastor deterrent system.
Listen,
me and the I basically was like in a moment of need, so I asked the merchants, what can we do about this pastor? Because we need to drive him off, but not kill him. The first option, it was by a French guy, one of the French merchants, bless his soul, but I don't think it was a realistic plan because he tried to convince me to train crows to attack him on command. And the way that we would do it, we would take a picture. I would take a picture of his face, and then I would like eat a seed and then peck the picture of his face. Then if a crow learned to peck the picture of his face, I would give it a seed. Then they learn that they get rewarded when they attack him. So they would just systematically attack him when he's in the area, come to me for seeds, and then they'd actually, you know, get rewarded. However, that does sound like it would take a lot of time to train. Another thing that we thought about doing was, like, we can buy a very small domestic drone. Now, a drone can actually have quite an impressive range, but it will still be controllable. And I have, like, a little alcove between the apartments, so I could fly that drone up, vertical, put it to the street, and then make it drop a payload, because you can put a grabber arm on it. Anyway, Ken, I wanted to fill that with either water, and if he doesn't get the message, I would escalate that to urine, or just something that's foul-smelling. I even considered actually buying skunk essence. Now, skunk essence would be very, very condensed skunk urine. You're meant to dilute that 1 to 1,000 to get the real stench you get from a skunk.
But we ain't gonna dilute it.
No, it's incredibly expensive. Ken, for skunk essence, it literally costs about £34 to get like a small bottle.
That's not that bad, especially for a prank, bro. Just
it's to chase him off. Anyway, after that, it would escalate to oil balloons, because oil you just can't wash off. Now, all of these plans, they sound really great in principle, but it is something that takes a while to actually set up. Now, I ended up at the end of the day buying a balaclava. listen, it gets better.
As one does.
I bought a balaclava, and I got a high-range water gun. I wouldn't really call this a water gun. This is a pump-action
many-liter gun with a range of 50 meters that can actually shoot like a truck. And this is the best deterrent that I've actually come up with. Now, unfortunately, to avoid the echo, I can't have you in the call. I think we can just mute each other. I'll show this on stream. And we can reconnect shortly after this is done. This is going to be the finale.
And I'll just throw more slutty elves at you in the meantime.
Oh yeah, thank you. I always appreciate that. By the way, this is not a fucking hate crime. Water is not assault. Okay. Anyway, I'll see you soon, boy. I'll see you soon. Okay. Listen, fellas. Let me turn everything on. Now you've heard about all of this. So there's technical difficulties here. Does this work? Holy shit. The fucking camera actually works. Now listen. Obviously I want the pastor cam to be much bigger now. I'm hoping people actually can see this. Wait. Transform. Fit the screen. How does that work?
You!
No. You will never see my fucking face, or at least I hope not. I hope you can't hear the fucking camera, because that's kind of pointless. Wait, can I just show, like, how badly my stress has been since I moved here? Can I just show you how many ciggies I got? Wait, does this work? Ah, it fucking works. Yeah, this is how many fucking ciggies I've smoked here. I keep a whole stack here just to remind myself how I'm fucking up my life. Anyway. Let me put on the technical difficulties. Fellas, I got a... Please have like a little distraction. Here's a little distraction. Here's a distraction song. I need to actually put on my fucking, what's it? You know, the black suit. I need to put on my fucking morph suit to conceal my identity and my balaclava. And I need to load my shotgun. And then I'll show you my pastor deterrent system. I'll be right back.
Hey, check this out, man. It was this blind man, right? Man, check it. It was this blind man, right? He was feeling his way down the street with this stick, right?
Yeah.
Hey, he walked past this fish market. You know what I'm saying?
Fish market.
He stopped. He took a deep breath. He said, "Woo! Good morning, ladies." You like that shit, man?
I'm pretty good.
Hey, man, I got a gang of that shit, man.
Hey, you ought to get
I tell you what,
man.
My man on the guitar, hey, fool on the drum.
Right.
Hey, everybody just crowd around the mic. I tell you all these motherfucking jokes
I got, man.
Let's clap it. First, I'm going to start off like this. Hey, help me sing it, homeboy. Come on.
Say Coke 45 and two zigzags. Baby, that's all we need. We can go to the park after dark, smoke that tumbleweed. As the marijuana burn, we can take our turn singing them dirty rap songs. Stop and hit the ball like Cheech and Chong. And sell tapes from here to Hong Kong. So roll, roll, roll my joint. Pick out the seeds and stems. Feeling high as hell, flying through Palmdale, skating on Dayton rims. So roll, roll the 83 Cadillac Coupe to Ville. If my tapes and my CDs just don't sell, I bet my cabbie will.
Well, it was just sundown in a small white town. They called it Eastside Palmdale.
Well,
when the Afro man walked through the white land, houses went up for sale.
Hell.
Well, I was standing on the corner selling rap CDs when I met a little girl named Jan.
Jan.
I let her ride in my caddy cause I didn't know her daddy was the leader of the Ku Klux Klan. We fucked on the bed, fucked on the floor. Fucked so long I grew a fucking Afro. Then I fucked to the left. Fucked to the right. She sucked my dick till the shit turned white. To myself, Sheba Sheba got my ass looking like a zebra. I put on my clothes and I was on my way
until her daddy pulled up in a Chevrolet.
So I ran, I jumped out the back window, but her daddy, he was waiting with a 2x4. Oh, he beat me to the left, he beat me to the right. The motherfucker whooped my ass all night.
Damn.
But I ain't mad at her prejudiced dad. That's the best damn pussy I ever had. I got a bag of weed and a bottle of wine.
I'ma fuck that bitch just one more time.
Go 45 and two zigzags, baby, that's all we need. weed. And as the marijuana burn, we can take our turn singing them dirty rap songs. Stop and hit the bong like Cheech and Chong and sell tapes from here to Hong Kong. So roll, roll, roll my joint. Pick out the seeds and stems. Feeling high as hell, flying through Palm Bells, skating on Dayton rims. Come on, so roll, roll the 83 Cadillac Coupe de Ville. If my tapes and my CDs just don't sell, I bet my cabbie will. I met this lady in Hollywood. She had green hair, but damn, she looked good. I took her to my house, cause she was fine, but she whooped out a dick that was bigger than mine. I met this lady from Japan, never made love with an African. I fucked her once, I fucked her twice. I ate that pussy like shrimp fried rice. Don't be amazed at the stories I tell you.
Tell you.
A woman in the heart of Australia had a big butt and big titties too. So I hopped in her ass like a kangaroo. See, I met this woman from Hawaii, stuck it in her ass and she said, aye. Lips was breakfast, pussy was lunch, then her titties busted open with Hawaiian punch. Met Colonel Sanders' wife in the state of Kentucky. She said, I brought some chicken if you just fuck me. I came in her mouth, it was a crisis. I gave her my secret blend of herbs and spices. Coke 45 and 2 zigzags, baby, that's all we need. We can go to the park, got the dogs, smoke that tumbleweed. And as the marijuana burn, we can take our turn singing them dirty rap songs. Stop and hit the ball like Cheech and Chong.
Hey, wait a minute, man, check this out.
I met Dolly Parton in Tennessee. Her titties were filled with Hennessy. That country music really drove me crazy, but I rode that ass and said, yes, Miss Daisy. Met this lady in Oklahoma, put that pussy in a coma. Met this lady in Michigan. I can't wait till I fuck that bitch again. Met a real black girl down in South Carolina. Fucked her till she turned to a white albino. Fucked this hooker in Iowa. I fucked her on credit, so I owe her. Fucked this girl down in Georgia. Came in her mouth, man, I thought I told you. Met this beautiful, sexy hoe. She just ran across the border of Mexico. Fine young thing, said her name's Maria. I wrapped her up just like a hot tortilla. I wanna get married, but I can't afford it. I know I'ma cry when she get deported.
Go 45 and 2 zigzags, baby, that's all we need. We can go to the ball, get the dogs, smoke that tumbleweed. And as a marijuana burn, we can take our turn singing them dirty rap songs. Stop and hit the bone like Cheech and Chong.
Hey, wait a minute, man. Hey, fuck that shit, huh? Have you ever went over a girl's house to fuck, but the pussy just ain't no good?
Say what?
I mean, you're getting upset cause you can't get her wet, plus you in the wrong neighborhood. So you try to play it off and eat the pussy, but it take her so long to come.
Say what?
Then a dude walk in, that's her big boyfriend, and he asks you where you from. So you wipe your mouth and you try to explain. You start talking real fast, but he already back.
Hey, yo, what's good? I gotta be honest with you people. So that's the, this is gonna be the end of the stream very soon. I'm gonna show you my pastor deterrent system. And one thing I gotta say, it is really hard to breathe in a morph suit while wearing a balaclava over your goddamn mouth as well. I can't really even read fucking chat. Now, yeah, let's do a goddamn pastor cam. Let's go. I don't have time for editing this shit. If I'm way too identifiable, then this is my goddamn mistake. Yo. Like my cup? Wait, where the fuck is my cup? Says I operate on coffee, sarcasm, and mascara. I got some good shit here. Hey, boys. Right. This is very hard to see in this goddamn thing. So, I am, this looks about right. Anyway, I'm gonna do a test shot of my shotgun here. Right, let's do this. Is this viewable? This viewable, like, let's, I can tilt this thing up, right? Hey. Okay. Right, can I be seen? Yeah, good shit. Don't worry, I'm a muscular looking man. I need to put on some goddamn nice music. Here. Give me a second. Let me put on some good background for you people. How the fuck do I see the keys? Yeah, this is perfect music for this. Yeah. Anyway, let's do this. And by the way, I've never actually done this in the past here. This is just a deterrent just in case. Outside my place. They get a non-lethal dose of water.